Union College is a tobacco-free campus. Smoking and chewing tobacco is not permitted on campus. Thank you for your support of Union's initiative for the health and wellness of our student-athletes and community members. Brown Coach is the official charter company and a proud supporter of Union College Athletics. Call Brown Coach or Brown Travel for all of your charter and travel needs.
Hello and welcome to Frank Bailey Field on the campus of Union College for today's non-league game that pits the Union College Dutchmen against the Utica College Pioneers. Andrew Santillo with you here in the broadcast booth from Frank Bailey Field. It is a sunny and cold afternoon here in the Capital District. And if you live outside of the Capital District, this morning we were waking up with temperatures in the low 20s to teens, so our first real taste of winter, but it feels all right for Union College. They are headed to the NCAA tournament after last week's big victory at Ithaca, improved the Dutchmen to 8-0 overall, 5-0 in the Liberty League, and with that win, the Dutchmen win the Liberty League title no matter what happens next week in the Dutchmen Choose game. They will win the Liberty League title for the first time since 2011 when they shared the title with Hobart. However, the Statesmen won the tiebreaker, and Union College has punched its ticket to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 2006. It'll be the 12th appearance for the Dutchmen in the Division III NCAA tournament. And the first time since 2006, also went back in 2005. That was the last year Union went 10-0, something the Dutchmen are trying to do this season, finished a regular season 10-0, but two games still to play, including this afternoon against the Pioneers from Utica College. So once again, Union at 8-0, ranked 14th in the country, has bigger games on the horizon. However, if you talk to Union head coach Jeff Behrman, he knows that this afternoon's game is certainly important, even though it's a non-league game, because the Dutchmen want to finish this season unbeaten and head into the NCAA tournament at 10-0. Of course, the big victory last week at Ithaca, 31-21, and the Dutchmen now 8-0, one of 12 remaining undefeated teams, Division III teams in the country. Last time the program was 8-0 was back in 2005. Again, that was the year the team finished off the regular season 10-0, defeated Ithaca in the NCAA tournament. That was before Ithaca was in the Liberty League, and then lost to Rowan in the second round of the NCAA tournament. Today's opponent, Utica College. The Pioneers have never lost to Union for meetings previously. This is the fifth all-time meeting between these two schools. They played for four consecutive years from 2011 to 2014. Utica winning all of those games, all four of them. A couple of them were close, including the most recent meeting back in 2014 here at Frank Bailey Field, that the Pioneers won 23-16, and the Dutchmen actually led that game 16-0. As we know, though, 5 years later, much of the teams are looking different, the two programs. Utica College comes into this afternoon's game at 4-4. The Pioneers are a member of the Empire 8 Conference and coached by Blaise Fagiano, who is in his 12th season with Utica College. Only the second coach in the program's history. The first season for Utica back in 2001 under head coach Mike Kemp. And Blaise Fagiano took over in 2007 in his 12th season. Ithaca College graduate, career record of 58-63. For Union, fourth-year head coach Jeff Behrman has this program back in the NCAA tournament. Coach Behrman following back-to-back seven-win seasons with 8 wins this year and counting. And he's got a four-year record of 25-13. Named the Union College head coach back on January 15th of 2016, a 1995 graduate of John Carroll University. As the team's making their way out onto the field, we'll hear from head coach Jeff Behrman in just a moment. And we will also be joined, we've got a couple of special announcements. Tonight is the Union Athletics Hall of Fame banquet, and one of the members of the class of 2019 is Tom Arcidiacano, and Union football fans are certainly familiar with that name. And Tom Arcidiacano, class of 2007, played on those teams that most recently went to the NCAA tournament. He is going to participate in the coin toss here before we start this this afternoon's game. And then Tom's going to try to join us here in between the first and second quarters. And he is part of the class of 2019. And this is the college's 14th induction class, which includes five former All-Americans, Tom Arcidiacano, women's soccer star Brittany Cressman, softball record setter Julie Goronsky, men's hockey trailblazer Jack Rankin, and field hockey groundbreaker Carolyn Zuttle, as well as longtime men's soccer coach Bob McGee and pioneering head coach Martha Morrison. In addition, the 1975 men's soccer team and the 1999 women's lacrosse team will be inducted as teams of distinction, and that is this evening. So, Tom Arcidiacano, you saw him give a wave there. He is at midfield with the Union College captains, Evan Gilland, George Reed, and Griffin Beal. Utica College has its captains out there for the coin toss. Jack Derby, Antonio Scala, Michael Carr Johnson, and Peyton Miller are the four Utica College captains. And again, if you're just joining us here, it is a sunny day, but it is rather cold. We're going to have forecasts in the mid to upper 30s. Certainly the coldest game of the season to date. So Union, it looks like, won the coin toss, and they are going to receive. And we're about ready to get underway. You're going to hear from Union head coach Jeff Behrman here in just a second. You're listening to Union College Football. Back here in the pregame before the Union's matchup against Utica College, joined as always by Union head coach Jeff Behrman. Coach, playing Utica this afternoon, but I think we'd be remiss without talking about last week's game at Ithaca. You win the league title, you improve to 8-0, and you clinch the program's 12th appearance in the NCAA tournament. Maybe what does that mean to the players and coaches, especially the older guys who came in here, maybe didn't have as much success, and now, they're headed to the NCAA tournament?
I'm certainly happy for them, happy for the program, happy for the school. It's a product of a lot of hard work, a lot of dedication, commitment on a lot of different levels. So, for everyone involved, I think it was a big, big step, and certainly earned by a lot of people.
And you jump out of league play this afternoon against a Utica team from the Empire 8, not that far away, maybe about 2 hours, hour and a half west of here. For people maybe who don't know that much about Utica, they've had a strong year, maybe some ups and downs, but they beat Alfred last week. So this is a good team coming in at 4-4. What do you expect against Utica this afternoon?
Well, I expect their A game. They're a big, strong, physical, and athletic football team. They can beat you in a lot of different ways, offense, defensively, special teams. I think they're very strong. Blaze Fagiano and his staff do a great job. Have a lot of respect for them. I know he's going to have his guys ready to play, certainly. And, we have to make sure that we stay disciplined and stick to our game plan as well.
Obviously, a key, we've been talking about it all season, has been the play up front of your guys on the offensive line and the defensive line. The offensive line, as a group, gets honored this week by D3Football.com on their team of the week. Didn't allow any sacks last week against Ithaca. And then, of course, defensively putting pressure on their quarterback, German Ariel. Just maybe comment on both. I guess the games are one up front. I mean, offense and defensive line, and what your guys have been able to do this year.
Yeah, that's our belief as a program, is that it is one up front. And, you know, it's great credit to our O-line. I was happy to see them get recognized that way. But certainly that's what, you know, our defensive line and offensive line have been doing all season. In every single game, it's been a game that's been won up front and in the trenches. And those guys take a lot of pride in it. They don't necessarily need the recognition. They just kind of go to work every single day and everything every single Saturday. And, you know, it's great to see that from them.
Hey, Coach, one more. You guys are averaging over 200 yards through the air and 200 yards on the ground. It's been a balanced attack. Is that basically what you were looking for? I mean, more or less? I mean, if you can come out 50% run, 50% pass, you feel like you guys would be in good shape?
Yeah, I mean, that's always the goal, is to be as 50-50 as possible from an offensive perspective, just to keep the defense off balance there a little bit, not let them zero in on just one thing. So, you know, I think, again, you know, we're playing well as a collective group, and you know, we have a lot of different guys we can get the ball to, whether it's on the ground or in the air, that can be productive with it.
Thanks, Coach. Best of luck. We'll be right back. Kickoff between Union and the Utica College Pioneers coming up after this.
And we are underway here on the kickoff. We had a penalty trying to sort this out today. We didn't think maybe we'd hear from our referees this early. It looks like the penalty is going to be against, maybe they wiped it off. Our referee today is Vince Joy. Umpire Robert Murray. Headlinesman Joe Granchielli. Line judge Nathaniel Riley. Field judges Derek Rydell. Side judge Kevin Gentz. Back judge Colin Bittner. The game clock, Joe Dunleavy up here, and the play clock is Mike Caligaro. First snap of this game is a pass from Bellamy to Reed Jr., Ross Jr., rather, and it's a short pickup, maybe not even any yards, as it's back to the 20. So the quarterback for your Union College Bomber, Union College Dutchman, is William Bellamy. Bellamy has completed 67% of his passes, 1,500 yards through the air, 16 touchdowns against only two interceptions. This pass a little ahead of Ross Jr. And it'll bring up third down. Third down and 10 here for the Dutchman. First possession, only 35 seconds into this one. Again, if you're just joining us, it is a cold afternoon. The sun is out. However, the forecast in the mid-30s, and everyone bundled up here on the sidelines at Frank Bailey Field. Three receivers. Bellamy gets the shotgun snap. Looking to the near side, making the catch, and a first down. Finn Duran makes the catch for the first down. So the completion to Finn Duran, who's out there early here in this first quarter, makes the catch. Now they're looking for him again. Here's Duran. He's wide open. Makes the catch at the 30 and stumbles and falls down at the 25-yard line. So Finn Duran, a big play from Bellamy to Duran. There was a couple of whistles. I don't see any flags down. So Union's going to have the ball first and 10 at the 25, and Coach Behrman pulling out some new plays here with Finn Duran out there, and obviously Utica College hasn't seen that on the game film. And so Duran was wide open, and he would have scored a touchdown, except he stumbled and fell at the 25. So Union, after a third and 10, now looks like actually now they're going to march off a penalty here. I didn't see a flag down on the field, but there's going to be a penalty on Utica, and it looks like it's going to be half the distance, as they're going to move the ball inside the 15 to about the 12 and a half, And Union's going to have it first and 10. So from third and long to now first and knocking on the door, they're going to look for Ross Jr., and it's incomplete. Looking for Ross Jr., they've seen that play a few times where they just kind of faded up to the big 6'3" wideout from Washington, D.C., who has 23 receptions coming in. Again, Union has been a balanced offense, averaging 36 points per game, 415 yards, 211 through the air, 204 on the ground. And you heard Coach Behrman in the pregame say, we'd like to be 50-50. Here's I.K. Irabor, first carry for I.K., and he maybe gets a yard and a half down to the 11. Irabor had another big game last week, 3 touchdowns against the Bombers, has 9 career 100-yard rushing games in only 16 games. I.K. Irabor looking to go over the 1,000-yard mark, already has 22 career touchdowns, just a sophomore from Braintree, Massachusetts. So third and long here for the Dutchman. 3 receivers. Tight end Crystal goes in motion. Pass completed again. This is Duran, but Utica snuffs this one out. And a flag flies after the play, and I don't know if Utica got up a little too excited after that third down stop. Anthony Bobron up from the secondary, number 7 from West Hempstead. And it's going to be on Utica. So 2 big penalties against the Pioneers on this opening drive. You expected both teams to come out with some energy. Of course, Union, obviously, with undefeated. They're ranked in the top 15 in the country. Utica with a chance to come east a couple of hours. They've got a lot of players from this area, so you knew they would have some fans in attendance. But Utica's had a couple of big penalties on this opening drive. Here's Irabor picking his way, looking for a hole. Tries to drive it right up the middle, and he's stuffed up. Behind the big offensive line for Union College was honored this week by the D3Football.com as the offensive line of the week. Didn't allow a sack last week at Ithaca. Tim Driscoll is the left tackle. Chris Cacciaduri in the left guard. Ryan Eretz is the center. Teddy Hood, the right guard. And Max Langsam is the right tackle. You've got 2 juniors, 2 sophomores, and a freshman on an offensive line that is youthful but certainly experienced at this point of the season. Here's Irabor. Another carry up the middle looking for a hole. Couldn't find much, got inside the 5 to the 3, and it's going to bring up third down. Union's had a couple of third downs on this drive, the 1 long pass to Duran, and then the Utica stopped them, but a penalty, dead ball penalty, gave Union a first down. Dutchman trying to get out here early in the first 4 minutes of this game. First drive, Bellamy rolling right. Looking for Ross Jr., tried to squeeze it in, and it's incomplete. Elijah Bell, who Coach Blaise Fagiano called maybe the best cornerback in the Empire 8 Conference, was in coverage, has a team-high 3 interceptions this year. Ross Jr. couldn't grab it. It would have been a terrific throw and catch. So Union's going to bring out the field goal team. Here's Marcos Rodriguez. They're going to set up for what would be a 20-yard field goal. Rodriguez is 4 of 6 this season. The hold is down. It's blocked. Bobbled around, though. Utica touched it. I think they covered it up, though. They came right up the middle and blocked the field goal. The snap was good. The hold was down from Christian, and it was blocked right up the middle. I didn't see a number on it, but Utica... Well, the defense made a couple of mistakes with some penalties, but they get a big block. They probably should have gotten away from that ball. It should come out. So the ball's going to come out to the 20-yard line because I guess they said it went into the end zone. It was bouncing around there. There was a lot more players around the football than probably there should have been, especially from the Utica side, because once you block it, you get away from it there. So Utica will have it first and 10 after the Pioneers get a big block field goal, 11:32 to go in the opening quarter. And Ryan Van Galen is your quarterback for the Pioneers. He'll hand off on first down and give it to senior running back Brad Doherty, who goes to the right side, picks up about 5 yards on first down. Starting offense for the Pioneers up front, Michael Carr Johnson, Ryan McCormick, Ben Wiedis, Nick Badalimente, and Matt Nell are your offensive line in front of Ryan Van Galen, who's a local guy from Clifton Park, New York, not too far from here. And back-to-back runs with Doherty, and he's got a first down. Brad Doherty, last week against Alfred, went over 100 yards, 25 carries, 101 yards for Doherty, who has 370 yards and been splitting time with Jamorius Morgan, who we'll also see this afternoon, had been nicked up, missed the Brockport game a couple of weeks ago, but was back last week against Alfred. The receiver to watch for the Pioneers is senior co-captain Peyton Miller, number one. Handoff, this is Miller, taking the handoff in the backfield, and he's going to be tracked down and taken down in the backfield as DeCaterino and Gilland in there, also Colin Lama, as Union pursuing to the ball and making a stop. It'll be second down and 11 from the 30. Union College starting defense, Vincent DeCaterino, Dan Gioso, and Tim Guiney up front. Two captains in the linebacking core, George Reed and Evan Gilland, along with Cass Knox and Colin Lama. The secondary, Paul Chambers and Travis Denby are your corners. And the safeties, Joe Vanderhoof and Austin St. Pierre. Van Galen rolling to his right, looking downfield, and it is incomplete. Receiver took a big hit there. It was the senior tight end, J.J. O'Connor. So it'll be third down and long. Actually, out on that other corner for the Union College defense is Brandon Scadlock at corner. For a terrific defensive unit led by defensive coordinator Rick Flanders, 19th in the nation and only allowing 14 points per game. Also 32nd in the nation, just 284 yards allowed per game. Have 21 sacks and 14 interceptions through 8 games. Here's Van Galen on third and long over the middle, and it's complete. And getting a first down is Kevin Warmack. So Warmack, the junior receiver, his 10th reception, came in with just 9 catches, but makes a big one there and gets Utica out to the 43, where it'll be first and 10 Pioneers. So when we talked to Utica coach Blaise Fagiano, he thought maybe some of the keys, who can run the ball, who can stop the run, and the special teams, and obviously always turnovers, play a big role in who's going to come out on the right side of the game. Van Galen hands it off. That's Jamarius Morgan. And Morgan taken down in the backfield, well, right at the line of scrimmage by Dan Gioso, the junior from Walpole, Massachusetts, whose 5 sacks lead the Dutchman defense. Utica's first offensive possession midway through this first quarter. Van Galen's going to toss it up, looking for Miller, and it's knocked away. Scadlock in coverage, and he's a little slow to get up. They were looking for Peyton Miller, the senior from Chemung, New York. Scadlock still down, but he went up and did a nice job to get a hand in there and knock it away from Peyton Miller, who got a lot of good praise from his head coach. Has 43 catches coming into this afternoon's game, 79 catches a year ago. And Coach Fagiano didn't have enough good words to say about Peyton Miller, his senior co-captain. Scadlock, making his way off the field. He's done a terrific job at corner this year, the junior from Beechwood, Ohio, 26 tackles this season, being helped off by trainer Cheryl Rockwood. It'll bring up a third down and long. Both teams have converted third down opportunities. Utica had a third and 10 that it converted to Warmack. It was about a 13-yard pass on third down, 12 or 13 yards. So third and long for Van Galen and the Pioneers. Slaps a couple times, tries to get Union to cross the line, almost did. Now he'll change the play. He's got four receivers, three here to the near side. Shotgun snap, pressure comes up the middle. Van Galen puts it up, and it is incomplete, and a flag comes in. And they're going to get Chambers, I think, for a push-off or a hand into the Utica receiver. Chambers was just trying to turn around himself and really didn't have to do that. You could see it up here. Chambers did extend the hand. Didn't really need to, I don't think, as Van Galen lofted that ball up. So we've had some big penalties in the first half of this first quarter. Utica had two 15-yard penalties, and there a 15-yard penalty that moves the football into the Union side of the field. First and 10, Utica. That was a third down that they get the penalty on. It'll be first and 10 at the Union 43. Van Galen takes the snap. Flag flies. They give it to Morgan. And Morgan fighting his way inside the 35, but it's looks like it's going to come back here as a procedure call against the Pioneers is going to back up Utica. This Utica team, 4-4, 2-3 in the Empire 8. They have beat Alfred. St. John Fisher started the year 2-0 with wins over St. Lawrence and Buff State, a couple of Liberty League members. So that's going to wipe out the Morgan run. And it'll be first and 15 back at the 47. Pioneers and the 14th-ranked Dutchmen are scoreless here in the first quarter. This is Utica's first drive. They got a lot of people moving around here. A lot of motion. They empty backfield now. Five receiver set for Van Galen. Quick throw, ooh, and it's almost intercepted. Hit Evan Gillen right in the hands, and Gillen just couldn't bring it in. The senior from Westport, Connecticut, co-captain on this linebacking core. And Gillen, who has 54 tackles coming in, also has a TD fumble return and interception this season. Was maybe staring at another one there, and it just couldn't bring it in. Utica tried to change it up there with five receivers, and Van Galen got rid of it quickly. No blockers in the backfield. Now he's got Doherty back there with him. He's going to look for him, and DiCaterino bats it down, and it's going to be incomplete third down. Well, Vinny DiCaterino has been a force on defense for Union this year, the 6'2" defensive lineman. 12 tackles for loss. He has an interception, 4.5 sacks, and he got back there and knocked it down with his big mitt. And it'll bring up third down and long. Third down at 15 for Utica, 7:40 to go here in the opening quarter. Still scoreless. Van Galen gives that slap as if he's expecting the ball and trying to maybe draw Union off, pick up a couple yards on a penalty. Changes the play. Again, four receivers, three to the near side for Van Galen. Drops back, has time. Airs it out. He's got a man. It is complete, and it's going to be close to the first down. Completed it to Nate Palmer. They're going to move the sticks here on third and 15. Utica gets exactly what it needed to the 32 with Nate Palmer. 14th reception of the year for the sophomore out of Verona. So on third and 15, Utica converts. They get 15 and move the ball to the 32. First and 10, Pioneers. Van Galen, a couple of slaps. Now he hands it off. running right and being brought down in the backfield as DeCaterino and Lama close in on Tim Hogan, the junior running back from Glen Cove, New York. So we've already seen a couple of Utica running backs, Morgan, Doherty, and now we see Tim Hogan. Long drive for Utica after the blocked field goal. Union drove all the way down the field and had a field goal blocked. Van Galen slaps, now gets the ball to the running back. Again, that's Hogan. And Hogan, with a head of steam, goes inside the 30 to the 28, pickup of four. And it'll be third down again. So Union defense trying to get off the field. Utica has a very capable kicker in Makai Medici, nearby Water Valete native, who has hit a field goal from 48. In fact, hit that field goal last week. He was 4-of-4 from field goals against Alfred, was named to the D3 team of the week, the same team that the Union offensive line was named to after their good performance last week at Ithaca. Third and six, Van Galen. Drops back, pocket collapses, pass is off the hands of the receiver. In coverage was Denby, looking for Anthony Goff. So it'll bring up fourth down, and I believe they're going to bring in the field goal kicker. Cheryl Rockwood coming out to look at DeCaterino's helmet, I think, has an issue. So he stayed down on the field. So they're going to bring in Medici. He's 14 of 15 for field goals this year, long of 48. This is going to be a 45-yarder for Makai Medici. From the right hash, Medici's kick is up. It is off the crossbar. So Medici gave it a ride, almost had enough leg, and it hit the crossbar and bounced off. So both teams have missed a field goal here in this first quarter for Medici. That's only his second miss of the season. 14 of 16 now for field goals for Makai Medici, who also leads Division III, 1.75 field goals per game. So the missed field goal will give Union okay field position, and the Dutchman will have it first down and 10 at their own 28-yard line. 5.5 to go here in this first quarter. Here's Erebor. Erebor trying to spin away, and he gets swallowed up by Shane Walpole and Jack Derby, a couple of local guys, Walpole from nearby Mechanicville, and Jack Derby from another Section 2 guy from Fonda, New York. We'll give you the starters for the Utica defense after this play. Second down and 11 after Erebor lost a yard. So Union's had trouble getting the offense going, although they moved it all the way down the field and had a field goal block. Here's Ross Jr. on a sweep, almost lost his footing, now spins away and gets a first down out over the 40 to the 41. So things haven't been really clear for Erebor. They get Ross Jr. the sweep, if you will, the end around, and he's got some space, and now Union right on the football here, first and 10. Bellamy snap, gives it to Erebor. Looking to the left side, trying to get up to the 45, and it'll be a four-yard pickup for IK Erebor. Up front for the Utica defense to start, Robbie Shemp, Shane Walpole, Andrew Caruso, and Jack Derby. The linebackers, John Nish, Kwasi Adu, and Antonio Scala. And in the secondary, Terrence Toussaint, Elijah Brown-Young, Anthony Beaubrun, and Elijah Bell. Erebor running to the left side, and he's met by a host of Utica defenders. Maybe give him one or two up to the 46, and it'll be third down and 5 for Union. So third down and 5 for the Dutchmen here. 3.5 to go in the first quarter. Bellamy drops back to pass. Some pressure comes. Beal makes the catch and can't go anywhere as he maybe leans ahead for a yard or two. Crossing route, Griffin Beal, who's had a terrific career, a senior from Reading, Massachusetts, his 37th reception of the season. But it's going to bring up fourth down as it only picked up 2 yards on third and 5, and Union is going to punt. Will Halpin out to punt, the senior from Latham, New York. Utica return man standing at its own 10-yard line. Short punt takes a Union College hop and roll, and now it's going to be downed right at about the 10-yard line. So Halpin, who averages 37 yards a punt, not his best, however, it took a nice roll and bounce, or I should say bounce and roll, and it's down at the Utica 11-yard line. .228 to go here in the first quarter. Utica comes back out for its second possession, first and 10 at the Pioneers' 11-yard line. Still scoreless here, Union and Utica College. Fifth meeting between these two programs. First meeting since back in 2014. I believe that was Morgan, Jamarius Morgan, sophomore from Utica, New York. Picked up a couple yards out to the 13, 2-yard pickup. Well, we talked about this Union defense. They are a stout group, 14 points per game allowed, and among the nation, the country leaders in points per game, yards allowed, and also rushing yards allowed. Sweep for Warmack. Warmack breaks away from a tackle. He's got some room. He's out over the 25-30, and he gets close to the 35. That's Kevin Warmack. Kind of a little end around that we saw Ross Jr. do on the last Union possession. And Warmack got out of the grasp of DeCaterino and brings it all the way out to the 34-yard line. First down for Utica. The Pioneers have come out ready to go here. Both teams have missed a field goal in this first half. Union's was blocked. Utica's hit the crossbar. This looks like Morgan again. Morgan's a small guy, 5'7", 175. Ran right up into the fray, if you will, where the line of scrimmage got a yard out to the 35. Second down and 9 facing Utica College. Van Galen slaps, gets the snap, and throws it wide of number 15, Keegan Wright. Was looking for the senior from Cicero, New York. That'll bring up third down and long. I wonder if Utica is going to kind of change that up. Van Galen has been, first of all, he's been slapping to try and get Union across the line. And then he's also been slapping when he's going to get the snap, which is obviously a pretty clear indication for the defense of when he's going to get the football. Van Galen looks back to the sidelines. 28 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Scoreless between the Utica College Pioneers and your Union College Dutchmen. Van Galen looks out of the backfield, comes Doherty, makes the catch. Not going to be enough for the first down as they get out over the 40. It's going to be 4th and 4, and they're going to bring out the punt team. Fourth down, So Makai Medici, who missed that field goal off the crossbar, he's also the punter for the Utica College Pioneers. Again, Shaker High grad. Averages 39 yards a punt. Standing back to receive it is Justin Faya. High punt. Faya looking into the sun, makes the fair catch at the 15-yard line with 15 seconds to go here in the opening quarter. And as we have about maybe one play remaining in this first quarter, we're going to be joined for a little bit of time here by Thomas Arcidiacano, class of 2007, and someone who's going to be inducted into the Union College Athletics Hall of Fame later this evening. And, Tom, it's great to have you here. We'll get some of your thoughts here after this first down play for the Dutchman, first and 10 from the 16. This is Ferrier running right up over Ryan Aritz, the center. Big run for Joseph Ferrara, the sophomore from Rocky Hill, Connecticut. And a big play for Union College Dutchman. That may be the final play of this first quarter, a scoreless first quarter, in which both teams missed a field goal. Union's was blocked, and Utica had theirs go off the crossbar. And Tom, just... I guess, what are your thoughts about being back here on campus? You know, you're not a guy, I think, that's from too far away. Originally, grew up in the area. But also, what does it mean to you to be inducted into the school's Athletics Hall of Fame later this evening?
Yeah, it's an awesome honor. You never think about that kind of stuff when you're playing. I honestly just love the game of football. So, you know, you stay in the moment when you're playing and you just want to win games. And me and the guys I played with, we had dreams of going undefeated and winning league titles and winning a national championship. But you never think about, you know, football afterlife, for lack of a better term. Because, you know, it's actually sad to think about it. You know, I've been able to go down memory lane a little bit this week, you know, in preparation for tonight, and a lot of fond memories, but also, you know, you get a little bit of sad, you know, it's jealous watching the guys out here today. But no, it's awesome. It's awesome to be back. It's also very cool timing with the fact that, you know, we went undefeated in 2005, and, you know, knock on wood here, we have an opportunity to do the same thing this year. So it's awesome. It's
yeah,
great to be back.
In fact, Union is 8-0 for the first time since 2005, the last time you guys went 10-0 in the regular season.
Yep.
So certainly a chance to do that. Again, being joined by Thomas Arcidiacano, class of 2007, who really, you know, the accolades are almost too much to list. Tom, I don't mean to flatter you, but finished your career 16th in Division III all time with 4,919 yards, still ranked 32nd overall. Basically rewrote all of the school record books in terms of rushing, as Ferrara, and Union's had a pretty good rushing attack this season with Ferrara and IK Irabor.
Two awesome backs.
Certainly two awesome backs. You were named to the Division III All-Decade Team of the 2000s, AFCA Division III All-American, Liberty League Offensive Player of the Year in 2005 and 2006, 54 touchdowns in 40 games. And you were a Gagliardi Trophy finalist during the 2005 season, in which you almost had 2,000 yards, 1,954 yards, and 20 rushing touchdowns. Pass over the middle, knocked away by Elijah Bell, who has been locked up with Ross Jr. That's certainly a matchup to watch. What does it mean, kind of, what is it like coming back here? You know, obviously, this program has a storied tradition, and it's going to be headed back to the NCAA tournament this year. What is it kind of like to be back on campus, you know, with a, you know, big crowd in the stands, that sort of thing?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, growing up, to me, I know Union has branded a hockey program now. We won the national championship, and that's awesome. It's great for the school, and I think some people do associate Union with hockey now. But for the longest time, and I hope for, you know, time to come, when I was growing up, and most people from the Capital Region, when you think about Union, you think about football. In the 80s, We went to the national championship. If you played high school football in the Capital Region, Union football camp was the camp to be because everyone wanted to get recruited by Union. And it's just, you know, we had a tough few years there. But Coach Barham has done an incredible job putting his footprint on this team, recruiting a lot of great players as we're watching out here today. I mean, this team does remind me a lot of the 05 team in the sense of we had a young quarterback in Anthony Marotti that came in when I came in. We had awesome two receivers. We had a tight end. We had me at tailback. And this offense that we have is, you know, scoring points like we did.
Yeah, they averaged 36 points a game through the first eight games. They had a long catch and run there from Ross Jr. Yeah, you mentioned it. I mean, you guys, and under your head coach, John Audino, and also Al Bagnoli, as a timeout being called by Utica College, and we're joined by Thomas Arcidiacano. You mentioned it. You're Columbia High guy.
Yep.
Grew up in a Section 2 guy. I mean, Union basically has had a storied football tradition. 12 NCAA appearances. You mentioned the Stag Bowl appearance. To have this team back in the top 25, I think is something where, you know, I don't think you can ever have those expect to be in the top 25 every year, but certainly those are expectations to have for the program.
Yeah, I mean, for the longest time, I think it was. I know when we were here, we didn't care if we were in the top 25. I think that's just a byproduct of winning a lot of games. But that was the expectation when you played at Union. I know when I came here, that was our expectation, was to win league titles, go to the playoffs, win playoff games. And we did. We realistically thought we could win a national championship. I think in 2005 we had the type of team that could do that. I was actually just talking with my buddies. We could in 2006 too. We just had a lot of injuries. A lot of things didn't shake out. You know, that's how sports go. But I think that should be the expectation. I think that's what Jeff's doing. And this team has the quality of players.
A lot of young players too who will be back next year too, which as Griffin Beal takes a handoff and gets to the 35-yard line. Still scoreless here, early second quarter. We're being joined by Thomas Arcidiacano, who's going to be inducted, part of the 2019 induction class, the Hall of Fame class. You mentioned it, 2006, the team went to the NCAA tournament in 2005, but that was the most recent time Union has been in the NCAA tournament, which they will be again by virtue of winning that game at Ithaca last week and winning the Liberty League title. Bellamy takes a shotgun snap, gives it to Ferrara running to the right side, gets about 3 yards close to the first down.
And, you know, today is interesting just speaking about this team and this game because I'm a huge sports fan in general. I played the sport. Today is a classic trap game. And so you really want to see them do something here before the quarter closes out because, you know, they locked everything up last week. You got the shoes next week.
Yeah.
You really couldn't create more of a trap game. So
this is a non-league game.
It's a non-league game. I wouldn't say that it's meaningless, but, you know, in sports, sometimes you get there's these games that get sandwiched in between two huge games, and sometimes there can be a bit of a letdown. So hopefully they can get some points on the board. And
certainly you said it. I mean, everyone had that Ithaca game circled for a long time.
Yeah.
You go on the road and win a big game. It'd be interesting to see kind of how they –
Well, when I lived it firsthand, too, in 2005, the year we went undefeated, you'd look back and look and say, oh, it looked pretty easy. There was a couple games there where, you know, we pulled a miracle, a rabbit out of the hat in two of the games. And sometimes you need that when you go undefeated. Just things don't work out. Teams scheme well against you. So it seems like Utica's bringing their best game
today. I think I remember, and this will probably show a little bit of my age, I think I ended up calling – a game against Coast Guard. I think there was a game
here.
That was like it took an intercept. It was like 3-3.
The game was 0-0.
0-0, okay.
And Coast
it was like
Guard,
a lousy weather day. There was no scoring. Yeah.
100%.
Yeah.
Yes.
And there was an interception.
There was a deflected ball down here at the 30-yard line. And actually one of my – he lived in our – we had a football house called 20U. One of my roommates, Alex Markell, who was a year or two younger, I think he was a year younger, caught the deflection and ran back for the touchdown that preserved the win. And it was the same kind of scenario as this. No one thought that Coast Guard was going to even give us a problem that day.
That was a big play. Fourth down conversion for the Dutchman to keep this drive alive. So first down and 10, Union keeping the offense on the field on fourth down. Here's Bellamy. He's going to look up top. Ross Jr. turns around. And there was a lot of contact. Bell locked up with him in coverage. Again, that's a matchup to watch. Coach Fagiano for the Utica side said he thinks Eli Bell is the best corner in the Empire 8 Conference.
Oh, well.
Told me he was a walk-on 4 years ago, and now he is 3 interceptions this season, 2 of those interceptions going back for touchdowns.
Well, hey, if you want to be considered one of the best cornerbacks in Empire 8 or D3, you're getting your prove yourself today against Andre.
Yeah, and they're locked up again,
a guy that they're going right back to it.
That's where Bellamy's looking, and Ross Jr.
No. Wow, good play.
Looked like he made the catch, but Bell, I think Bell thought he intercepted it, but he came down out of bounds. That was a wild play there, as I thought Ross was going to make an easy catch.
He looks like he took it out of Andre's hands as he was kind of bobbling a little bit, but he didn't get his foot down.
Right down on the sideline there. If they were maybe 5 feet further in, that could have been an interception. Bellamy has not had many of those, only 2 this season against 16 touchdowns, and that's been one of the biggest differences, I think, from William this year. Only 7 interceptions last year, but against 22 touchdowns, but he has not turned the ball over. Here's this little sweep play again that we've seen a few times, and Utica snuffs it out as the Pioneers will force a 4th down. We're being joined by Tom Arcidiacano, Union legend, almost 5,000 career rushing yards. Again, still ranks in the top 35 all-time in rushing. Union's going to keep the offense out on the field here on 4th down with 10:45 to go before halftime. Yeah, I can't believe we just thought about that Coast Guard game here. That is a game I actually called back in, I think it was 2005 season.
And we had a crazy one a few weeks before that out in Franklin Marshall. Once again, classic trap game. We'd come off a big win, 5-hour bus ride out there. They were an okay team. We knew their defense was going to be pretty good. But for anyone listening that remembers or didn't, it was – in the midst of our undefeated season, there was 7-8 seconds left on the clock. We were tied. I think we were either tied or we were down 4. And we essentially hit a streaking receiver. Almost, it was a glorified Hail Mary down the left sideline to win the game. It was crazy. So we had 2 games that year where it could have gone either way. And that's just the stuff that makes sports special. You just think back to it. And that was kind of our year. We had a chance to make a deeper run in the playoffs, but I think these guys have all the makings. The one thing that they have, too, that has really impressed me this year is, besides all the offensive weapons that I paralleled to us, the defense is awesome.
Yeah.
Defense is really, really good.
It's interesting you say that, because while the offense averages over 400 yards a game, the defense is only allowing 14 points a game, which is 19th in the nation.
Yeah.
And only 284 yards a game, which is 32nd in the country.
And they're opportunistic. Every game that I've watched, guys are making play on the ball, which, you can see that at all levels of football. Sometimes there's great athletes in the back end that drop interceptions or not in the right spot. This defense makes a lot of plays. Big play here.
Well, we're going to have a big play. 4th down and 10 for the Dutchman from the Utica 22. 3 receivers for Bellamy. Ferrara in the backfield with him. Drops back. Going to air it out.
Got him.
He's got a man. It looked like the ball maybe got hung up in the wind and knocked down. He was looking for Will Sermon, and the pass incomplete in the end zone. So passing game not really on track yet, although that one looked like some crazy wind knocking it down. And again, we're being joined by Tom Arcidiacano, who's generous enough to come up and join us for a few minutes here in this first half. You talked about life after football.
Yeah.
I bet when you come back here, like college, all the memories come back. And when you see the guys that you spent so much time with out on the field and off the field and on the practice field, so many of those memories, I'm sure, come back to you.
They do.
Run up the middle here on 1st down by Doherty. Picks up a couple.
That's the thing that I've reflected a lot this week, actually, in anticipation of tonight's event. And that's the crazy thing about sports is sometimes people just view football or some of these things as a game. And it is so much more than that. The people that you meet along the way and the moments that you're able to make, it bonds friendships and relationships that you have for the rest of your life. And you cannot put a price tag on some of the memories that guys make playing football.
Van Galen slaps for the snap, now hands it off, and Union defense right there, led by D. Catarino.
And I know for me, I still have so many great friends from the years that we played together. We still all talk, and we're super close, and I just don't think you could forge those types of relationships without the type of memories and the things that you go through together, you know, on an athletic field, not just football, but for us, it happened to be football. So I feel so blessed to have, you know.
Yeah, and I would probably say, adding to that, uniquely, football, you play one game a week. I mean, you really spend more time not playing than you do playing.
You do.
You know, it's not like basketball where you're playing 2-3 games a week. Third down and long, Van Galen puts it up. He's got Warmack, and Warmack tried to bring it in, and it slammed down off the turf and will go incomplete, looking for the junior from Utica, Kevin Warmack, who's already made a big catch on third down. Tried to do it just there. They had him. You said it. They had him. He had a step and just could not bring it into the ground. Yeah.
Yeah. It's funny because I actually was asked, you know, give me a couple of your favorite moments. And I feel like the stock answer is, oh, there's too many to really give you one. But that year we went undefeated. We played RPI the last week of the year. Like, these guys are gonna. And to make a long story short, ended up, you know, scoring on a long run that basically just ended the game for us. There was a few minutes left. We're trying to run the clock back. It was a shootout. We couldn't give them the ball back. We knew we'd lose the game and the score. But I got mobbed in the end zone by all my teammates and running back on the sideline. And this place, Time Warner had broadcast the game for the first time. It's more common now that they broadcast college and high school games. You could not see grass anywhere on this entire field. I'll never forget it. There had to be 10,000-plus people here. They were 8-1. We were 9-0. The winner was going to get the shoes, go to the playoff. But what I said to the person was, that feeling, that moment of joy, and that you can't manufacture.
Yeah, yeah.
You could never get that type of feeling in any other aspect, in my opinion. And, you know, I'm 34 years old. I've done a lot of things in life. There's a lot of joys. But as far as sports go, you cannot manufacture that type of natural emotion. So that's the cool thing about a team sport like football.
Short punt from Medici is going to set. Faye actually did a good job to come up and make the fair catch. He was kind of on a full sprint.
Yeah, it was really good. Ooh, he's going up top.
First
again.
Down, Bellamy's going to put it up. They've been trying to connect with Ross Jr. This time it's going to draw a flag. Well, that tells you what kind of player Ross Jr. is. Three Utica players down there on defense trying to tie him up. This year's Ryan Twitchell.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, we had Twitchell and Angeletta.
Yeah.
We had two guys, crazy.
Twitchell and Angeletta, and then Marotti at quarterback, and you in the running back.
I think both guys, one of them might have been just under. Actually, I think it was Twitchell. In 05, both of them almost caught for 1,000 yards. Crazy.
Well, I don't know if either of them are here, but Andre Ross Jr., through his sophomore year, closing in on 1,500 yards, 21 touchdowns, and 100 receptions.
Steve kind of rewrote the wide receiver record book when I was here, right? You know, doing the running, you know, rushing records. But I think Justin Gallo had kind of
had a nice career.
Yeah, and now you got Ross. So we always bust his chops.
Here's Ross Jr. I don't know. Oh, he kind of comes up a little sore going out of bounds.
That's not good.
And now motioning to the sideline for replaced.
It's not what you want today.
And this is really the first true cold day we've had in the Capital District, so tough to stay warm, and that's what it looks like. Ross is did not get hit on that play. Some sort of hamstring, although he was looking at the front, maybe. Yeah. And again, you mentioned classic trap game. This is also a game where Coach Behrman, you only have 10 games, so you're certainly trying to win all the games, but you've already got the league title wrapped up and the NCAA tournament and the shoes game next week. Now, I've kind of heard from other people.
This is the worst case scenario.
Well, how cautious are you with players who, when you know you have bigger games, although to get a home game, I would say you probably have to win all the games here.
Yeah.
So it puts you in an interesting spot. Obviously, you want to win every game.
There's no games that you don't want to win, but to your point, the worst thing you want to happen today is what we just saw. Hopefully, he's okay. But you lose a stud star player that you know you need to go deep in the playoffs. So hopefully he's okay. But that's the tough part about these kind of games. And like you said, it's a good point because as soon as I showed up here today, I said the same thing to my buddies. These first games, nice run. Oh, cut it.
Erebor cuts back in, and the Dutchmen are going to be set up first and goal after a nice run by I.K. Erebor.
That first really cold game, you get out there and you kind of hit the gas a little bit, and sometimes those muscles aren't warm. tough.
So Bellamy's got the offense quickly to the line. Utica trying to get substitutions off the field. First and goal. Bellamy quick snap. Fires it out to the far side. The flag flies. So they might get pass interference, although that was like a one-second play. I can't believe that they would throw. I mean, there were some I think it was Sermon was tied up with one of the defensive backs in the end zone.
Sometimes on those screens, they call pass interference in the offense when you're setting kind of a pick.
Oh, illegal block in the back. You said it, though. They're trying to set. Everybody's trying to get set up, and that's going to move Union back outside the 10, back to the 15. It's going to be first and goal from the 15. Well, Tom, we appreciate you joining us here. You know, feel free to hang with us here, but I know you've got other things to certainly attend to. Friends here, and you know, obviously you got the big induction ceremony tonight where you'll be inducted into the Union College Athletics Hall of Fame.
I appreciate you having me up here. Appreciate going back down memory lane. Hopefully we punch it in here.
Hopefully, as Erebor gets turned and tossed, hopefully we won't be reliving that Coast Guard game here late in this game. Although I didn't think we'd bring up Alex Markell in today's broadcast, but somehow, you know, sometimes you know, things work in mysterious ways here.
Exactly. But hey, I appreciate you having me up here.
Seriously, you know,
hopefully we get this win today.
Yeah, it's great to have you, and you know, certainly someone that Union College football fans know, Tom Arcidiacano, class of 2007, who rushed for 4,919 yards, still 32nd all-time in Division III. Here's Bellamy trying to set up a screen pass, and it was knocked away, although it was Sermon didn't have much green in front of him, looking for Will Sermon.
Well, hey, go you. Let's get the shoes next week to all the Union fans. It's awesome being able to share a few moments with you, and looks like we're all headed in the right direction as a program.
Yeah, and we appreciate you. Again, this 2019 team, the first team to go 8-0 since you guys did it back in 2005. You went on to go 10-0, beat Ithaca in the first round of the NCAA tournament, and then played Rowan in the second round, which you know, I don't want to leave you on a bad thought here.
Nah.
I don't want to leave you on a bad bad moment here as Erebor running left. Man, Union's offense has just kind of been stalled. We're midway through the second quarter, still scoreless between Utica and Union. And again, just want to thank Tom for stopping by here. He'll be inducted into the Union Athletics Hall of Fame, and Union's going to set up for a field goal here, as I believe that's Will Halpin.
Will Halpin with the field goal attempt.
Field goal up, and it is good. So Halpin comes out and knocks down the field goal and gives us our first points of the game, as they've used Halpin in further distances this season. He's 3 of 3 this season for field goals. Marcos Rodriguez had the first one in this game blocked, as both teams have missed a field goal in this game. So Union has it 3-0 lead with 6:42 remaining before halftime. And once again, we really want to thank Tom Arcidiacano for joining us up here for a few minutes in between the first and second quarters. From someone who covered or was around when Tom was here at Union, he was as dynamic a player as Union probably has ever seen. Again, was a Gagliardi Trophy finalist his junior season in 2005, ran for 1,954 yards and 20 touchdowns, 54 career touchdowns in 40 games. I mean, just unbelievable. I mean, to put that in perspective, I.K. Erebor, who's just had a fantastic start to his Union College career, has 22 touchdowns through basically his first 2 years. Arcidiacano had 54 touchdowns in 4 seasons here at Union College. Just unbelievable. Kickoff from Halpin down to the 10. And bringing it back out to the 30 is Tim Hogan. And that's where Utica will take over first down and 10. Union fans, visit Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady. Open for lunch, and dinner before or after Union games. It's the place to watch college football and hockey with friends and family. That's Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady. 6:36 to go before halftime. And at halftime, we'll have an interview with members of the offensive line. Again, they were honored with a D3 Team of the Week accolade after their performance last week at Ithaca. Shotgun snap for Van Galen and running up the middle, but no room as George Reed leading the way, the senior from Towson, Maryland, makes the stop behind the 30, so a loss of one on the play as that was Doherty trying to go up the middle. Shotgun snap. They're going to hand it to Morgan. Morgan trying to get the edge, and he is not going to get there. A host of Union defenders, including Evan Gilland, Denby, St. Pierre, and Lama. And staying down on the field is Jamarius Morgan, who has been banged up. Missed a game 2 weeks ago against Brockport. Back last week against Alfred. Had 12 carries for 55 yards, but he's down on the field. On the far, his far sideline, the opposite side of his, the Utica sideline. So the trainers come all the way across the field to look at Morgan, the sophomore from Utica. 3-0 Dutchman lead here, 5:41 to go in the first half. And Union fans, Brown Coach is the official charter company and a proud supporter of Union College Athletics. Call Brown Coach or Brown Travel for all of your charter and travel needs. So that pass, that play to Morgan actually lost yards. So back-to-back losing rushes by Utica. First Doherty, then Morgan. And then it brings up third down and about 13 for the Pioneers. Third down. Van Galen, four receivers, three to the far side. Snap, pressure comes up the middle, it's blocked. Coming right up the middle on the blitz. Mark Zazzaro coming right up the middle. The junior from Wethersfield, Connecticut, who has 18 tackles this season, came unblocked and knocked the Van Galen pass down. And Makai Medici will come out to punt. Medici, another high, high arcing punt. And another fair catch called for and made by Faya at the 44. And that's where Union will take over. Dutchman still trying to get the offense going. 5:20 left to go before halftime. It's 3-0. Fans, be sure to stop by the Center Street Pub, located at 308 Union Street in Schenectady, featuring TVs to watch all of your favorite teams, great food, and live entertainment. Center Street is a proud partner of Union College and Union College Athletics. Here's Erebor running left. He's got a big hole as he gets to the sideline. A lot of green. And gets the first down and into Utica territory to the 45 of the Pioneers. First real running room for IK Erebor. He's maybe had one or two good runs to this point. I can think of one down near the goal line on the last drive that got Union in a first and goal situation. Then they had the penalty that pushed them back out to the 15. Here's Ferrara running left, trying to get to that sideline, and a flag flies late. as Ferrara was knocked out of bounds.
There's a penalty marker on the field.
And this could be a big one on Utica. Late hit out of bounds is the call from our referee, Vince Joy. It'll move the football all the way inside the 25 to the 24 and give Union a first down. Third 15-yard penalty assessed against Utica in this first half. Union trying to make it cash in here. As they have it first and 10 from the 24. Running to the left is Ferrara, and he gets held up and taken down by 41 Ryan Oliver, the linebacker from Vernon Center, New York.
Ball plays at the 25-yard line, a loss of one. It will be second and 11.
Second down and 10 after that no gain run. Here's Beal, quick hitter. Beal's got a head of steam. He's going towards the goal line, and he's down inside the five. It'll be first and goal, close to the goal line, Griffin Beal. And Union's got it set up first and goal at the, they're spotting it at about the three, it looks like. Union quickly to the line. Low snap. They give it to Ferrara, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Touchdown, Union College, Joseph Ferrara.
That touchdown was scored by number 22, Joseph Ferrara.
For Ferrara, his ninth rushing touchdown this season. And Marcos Rodriguez out for the extra point with 3:27 to go before halftime. Kick is up, and it is good. So with 3:27 to go in the first half, it's Union College 10, Utica College 0. Union fans, Trusco Bank is a proud to be a leading community sponsor of Union College Athletics, offering residential mortgages, hometown checking, and friendly personal service. Trusco Bank has been serving our community since 1902. So Union finally getting its first touchdown here with just a few minutes to go before halftime. And the Dutchman leading it 10-0. Union College ranked 14th in the country in the Division III football, D3football.com poll, 17th in the country in the AFCA coaches poll. Short kick taken by one of the upmen for Utica at the 20. Out over the 30, takes a big hit, and that's where the Pioneers will take over. First down and 10. As I think that was, looked like might be Alex Oliver, who caught that pass for Utica, brought it out to the 33, where the Pioneers will take over. First down and 10 for Utica. Again, stick with us at halftime. We have an interview with members from the offensive line. Four of the five members before we recorded it before yesterday's practice. Union D-line shifts. Van Galen floating it out near the sideline, and it's incomplete, looking for number 15, Keegan Wright. Falls incomplete. Well, Utica has a lot of local players, and when I say local, I mean Capital District players, a lot of guys who played in Section 2, which is the area, the high schools in this area that are in Section 2 of New York State, including the quarterback Van Galen, who played at Shenandoah High School, and a couple, one or two at least, of their captains. Run up the middle, Union having none of it, as I think that was Doherty trying to get going, and he actually lost a yard. So it'll be third and 11. Doherty knocked backwards. It's going to be third and long for the Pioneers. Third down and 10 for, or third down and 11 rather, for Van Galen. He's got four receivers, three to the far side. Shotgun snap. Pressure coming up the middle. Spins out of it, does Van Galen. Now he throws it up to the sideline, and it's knocked away by Austin St. Pierre. Utica receiver Nate Palmer was the intended receiver. He was looking for a pass interference flag, but Austin St. Pierre jumped up in the air. The ball hit him in the back, it looked like. And it'll bring up fourth down, and out comes the Utica punt team with Makai Medici trying to punt it into the wind here. Faya standing at the Union 33. And a flag here as we get a false start on the Pioneers. Utica's had a lot of penalties in this first half. Ball moves back 5 yards. Medici still ready to punt it away for Faya standing at the 38. Signals the fair catch and makes it at the, and a flag goes down. Made it at the 39. Flag goes down. Kind of seen a lot of flags in this first half. 10-0, Union leads it with 2:14 to go before halftime. The referee's going to try and straighten this out. If you're just joining us, Union had a tough time getting the offense on track, but now has scored with a field goal and touchdown. They did have a field goal blocked in the first quarter. But also one thing to keep your eye on is Andre Ross Jr. After he made a couple of catches so far in this first half, on the last catch, he went out of bounds and was kind of favoring, was certainly in some discomfort and hasn't been back out there yet. So certainly something to keep an eye on. Again, this is really the first cold day that we've had, as the temperatures this morning were down in the teens and low 20s. Penalty was on Utica, so it'll bring the football into the Pioneer side of the field. Temperature right now is 37 degrees, and that's much warmer than it was even yesterday or this yesterday evening or this morning. Shotgun snap for Bellamy, turns and hands to Irabor. Irabor running left, gets inside the 45 to the 43, pickup of three. And now Irabor slow to get up. So this is not what you wanted if you are a Union College fan. You saw Ross Jr. Kind of nicked up, and now Irabor stays down. And now he'll get back up to his feet. Two minutes to go in this first half.
7.
Second down and 7 after the 3-yard run by Erebor, who's over here on the sideline trying to stretch out whatever got injured on that play. Ferrara comes in, replaces him, takes this carry on second down, goes inside the 40. It'll be about a 4-yard pickup to the 39, and it'll bring up third down and short. And now a Utica player is down, and that's senior captain Jack Derby. Derby from nearby Fonda, New York. Gets up to his knees, and now he's going to be looking for some assistance here as he stayed down after that second down play. Derby, 38 tackles coming in. Coach Blaise Fagiano said he's played all 4 positions on the D-line. Making his way off the field seems to be okay under his own power. Going to be third down and 3 for the Dutchman. Again, stay with us at halftime. A minute 39 to go here in the first half. Union leading at 10-0. As we'll have an interview, we'll take a look at some scores. Before we came on the air, we saw the score. RPI was leading Ithaca 21-0. That game started at noon. So we'll take a look at that score. Bellamy tried to set up the screen pass, threw it over the head of Ferrara, and it'll be fourth down. See if Coach Behrman elects to keep the offense on the field here. Fourth and short from the Utica 39. And they're going to bring in the punt team. Try to pin Utica deep. Final minute 27 of this first half. Utica has all 3 timeouts, so they have time. But what kind of field position are they going to have? Remember, Union ran a fake punt last week against Ithaca. I'm sure Utica is ready for that. Halpin end-over-end punt that bounces into the end zone for a touchback. Some pushing and shoving after the play. No flags fly. Union sideline was looking for a flag after one of the Union players got knocked down. I think that was Cam Adams, I believe, out on the punt unit. Linebacker from Saratoga Springs got pushed lightly by a Utica player and then hit the turf as if he had been hit by a ton of bricks. Trying to get that call. Utica's been called for a couple of penalties in this first half. Quick swing pass out of bounds goes Doherty. Goes out of bounds after about a 7-yard pickup. It'll be second and short for the Pioneers. Went out of bounds, so a minute 16 to go here in the first half. 10-0 Union leads Utica. 5th all-time meeting between these two programs. Utica has won all 4. Pass over the middle is caught. A little slant play, and now a timeout. Oh, no. Nope, they don't call timeout as the pass was completed to Keegan Wright out to the 41. Utica hurries to the line. Van Galen snaps it. Pass caught. Peyton Miller catches it. Clock's going to run as he gets up near midfield. 53 seconds, 52 seconds. Utica hurries to the line. I would have probably spent a timeout there as you only got 45 seconds left now. Here's Van Galen looking for Doherty out of the backfield, and it goes off of his hands, incomplete. So that'll stop the clock with 41 seconds to go here in the first half. Union leading Utica 10-0.
Ball
Again, at halftime, we'll take a look at some statistics, scores around the league, and we'll have an interview with some members from the Union College offensive line. Quick slant, complete, first down. It was thrown to Nate Palmer. Utica hurries to the line. They got to get... they tried to snap it and then spike it, and unfortunately, Kevin Warmack was not back on the line yet. He was hustling back to the line, but you got to be set for a second. And so that's going to move the football back 5 yards. Well, they're trying to figure this out, but I believe that's going to be a 5-yard offsides call or false start. And I think now Utica's going to take a timeout. So Utica's going to spend a timeout with 33 seconds left. The penalty moves the ball back to midfield. It will still be first down, though. They did spike it, but that was a pre-snap penalty. So it'll still be first down. Again, we want to thank Thomas Arcidi-Acano, class of 2007, for joining us in this first half. He'll be part of the 2019 induction class for the Union College Athletics Hall of Fame. Really, just a guy who, you know, if you follow the Union College program, certainly somebody you knew. He was Offensive Player of the Year in the Liberty League 2005 and 2006. D3 All-American, D3 All-Decade team in the 2000s, and topped the Union previous rushing record by more than 1,300 yards, finished with over 4,900 yards in his illustrious career. Pass over the middle, it's intercepted! Mark Zazzaro, his second interception of the season. And it'll be Union football, 15th interception of the season for the Dutchman. And as I said, the second for Zazzaro. So just like that, Utica was moving down the field. They get a penalty, and then Van Galen throws an interception for him. That is his third interception of the season for Van Galen. And now I think Union's just going to take a knee with 28 seconds to go in this first half and hit the locker room with a 10-0 lead. Bellamy turns, takes a knee, and that'll be the final play of this first half, although the play clock says 5 seconds. It never got reset. So that'll be the final play of this first half. An exciting first half. We didn't see many points, especially early on. Both teams missed a field goal in that first half. The score at halftime, your Union College Dutchman 10 and the Utica College Pioneers nothing. You're listening to Union College football here on unionathletics.com. Try to maybe get a look at the first half statistics, and then we've got an interview, as we said, with four members of the Union College offensive line, Tim Driscoll, Chris Kachadurian, the left tackle and left guard, and the right tackle and right guard, Teddy Hood, who's the right guard, and Max Langsam, who were the offensive line of Union was named to the team of the week by D3Football.com last week after the big win against Ithaca, in which they allowed no sacks and also led the way for 3 IK Irabor rushing touchdowns. So it's halftime here at Frank Bailey Field. Your score, Union College 10, Utica College nothing. We will take a quick break and be back with an interview with the Union College offensive line. It was we were happy to join with them, be joined by them previous to yesterday's practice. Again, 4 members of the offensive line. So we, again, will take a break and Then we'll, when we come back after that interview, we'll take a look at some first half statistics and also some scores from around the Liberty League on this cold afternoon at Frank Bailey Field. Your score is 10-0, Union leading it. You are listening to Union College Football.
We're back here. It's halftime of the Union game against Utica. We are joined by 4/5 of the offensive line for the Union College Dutchmen, who have done an excellent job this season, over 400 yards of offense averaging. These guys are leading the way. And so we're being joined by sophomore Tim Driscoll, junior Chris Kachadurian, sophomore Teddy Hood, and freshman Max Langsam. And they're actually, they're kind of not jumbled up here as I face them. But, we're talking to them. They had a nice accolade. Division3football.com named them the offensive line of the week after last week's performance against Ithaca, blocked for over 200 yards and 3 touchdowns for IK. I'll start with Tim, sophomore from Pleasantville. Just talk about maybe how you guys have been performing this year, and living up to the expectations. Obviously 8-0, so the wins are there, but how have you guys felt you've played as an offensive line?
Well, I think with four of the 5 starters from last year coming back, we definitely had high expectations, and just another year with Coach Ragonis, it definitely helps us out, and all the time we spend together, all the time we put in the off season, definitely we're looking to have a big year, and I think first few games we've put together games that we've liked, definitely some things to improve on, and we're nowhere near where we want to be at, so we're definitely still working hard to get better.
And Chris, you line up at left guard. You're one of the juniors. This is a younger group. You start a freshman, a couple sophomores, a couple juniors. What has it been like for a group that's a little bit inexperienced in terms of, or youthful, I guess I should say, not inexperienced, of kind of gelling together? And how would you guys say you have come together, I guess, as teammates and as a unit with the offensive line?
Yeah. So I was, we were all freshmen at one point. So. I know where this guy's been, we're young and need experience. Teach him along the way, everything I know. We as a group, we gel pretty well together. We're all, very good friends, and, we play well together. It correlates to the field, and I think we've done pretty good job so far this year.
Freshman Max Langsam lining up at right tackle, from a New Jersey native. Talk about maybe being the new guy on this offensive line. Obviously, we're well into this season, but what has it been to mean to block for this team? You got a great offense, obviously a lot of skill guys back. What has it meant kind of to be out there blocking for an offense that averages over 400 yards a game?
I mean, you got 4 out of 5 guys returning, so, being the new one's a little bit of a different situation, but, they're all good leaders. They're all very helpful, They work really hard, they teach you everything. If you have an experienced O-line, it's really easy to just come in and just really help out. So they've been doing a great job helping me out, teaching me the plays, technique, everything. We work hard, and when you have athletes to block for, a great quarterback to block for, a great system, it's pretty easy. It takes care of itself.
We're being joined here at halftime by 4/5 of the offensive line. Again, an offense that averages over 400 yards a game. Teddy, we'll bring you in here. Average over 200 yards rushing and 200 yards passing the football. Which do you guys prefer? Or do you personally prefer blocking for pass play or run play?
It's hard to say. We get a lot of big plays from both. But we've been in a few situations this year where we've helped IKL out a lot out. But there's been other plays where you think the play is completely over, and then all of a sudden we see IK 40 yards down the field jump to the outside. So I mean, it's obviously nice run blocking for IK. He bounces a lot of plays, but we just try to make his job easiest on level one. And once he gets into the open field, we know he can make a lot of plays. Having said that, it's obviously great blocking for Will, because we got a lot of outside receivers who can make plays too. So it's a nice combination of both. When we put up numbers like 244 on the ground or something like that, it's obviously nice for us, because we get, I guess, a bit more recognition than say if we're pass blocking, but a combination of the two is awesome.
again, being joined by four-fifths of the offensive line, the one member who's not with us, center Ryan Aritz, who was an all-league guy last year. But, Tim, you know, the big game against Ithaca, kind of everyone had that circled for a long time. I know that game is kind of over with now, but it meant so much to win the league, to stay undefeated, go on the road and post a nice win. What did that mean, especially when, you know, you guys had such a game plan and controlled the ball for 36 minutes? You guys were out on the field for a long time, and I think that was probably the game plan.
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely a game, winning the league has been what coach has been talking about, like, since he recruited me, since he recruited all of us. So, you know, like, winning that was huge for every single one of us. It means, like, a lot to us. But, you know, we got a lot more work to do. And we're focused on Utica this week, and we're excited for all the challenges ahead. So,
Chris, undefeated. You know, it wasn't that many years ago that there wasn't as much success. So it's been a nice turnaround, 2-7 win seasons, and now undefeated. Just maybe talk about what not a transformation so much, but as the team has come along and you know the talent kind of has come along, and it's gone from 7 wins three years ago to 7 wins last year, and then now 8-0, shooting for maybe double digits wins and continuing on.
Yeah, I mean, it all starts with Coach Behrman and the guys on this team creating the culture. You know, when I first got here as a freshman, we knew that at the end of the day, like, we wanted to win the league, and that was our goal. And finally achieving that as a junior, it's big, and it's testament to all these guys on our team. And every single day putting in the work, like, we're grinding, and we knew a couple years ago we weren't as good as we are now, and it's just testament to these guys who've been putting in the work, so.
Well, I'll say also, I mean, we talked about 223 yards on the ground last week, but how about didn't allow a sack? I mean, that's, Max, bring you in here. Is that, when we talk about goals for the season and goals for game to game, I have to imagine not allowing a sack is up there as one of them.
Definitely a huge one. You know, a sack is a big change of the game, change of momentum for the other team. You know, also, when you got a guy like Will, can really throw the ball around, try to keep him as confident, you know, as safe as possible, you know, not try to get him banged up. So to not give up a sack last week against, a good defense was huge for us. But coming into it, we were confident. We had a good game plan, and we just knew what we had to do, and we just did it.
Joined by four-fifths of the Union College offensive line here. It's halftime, Union game against Utica. And so maybe final question here, for Teddy. Obviously your goals, one goal was to win the Liberty League, accomplish that, and with that, the trip to the NCAAs. What maybe is the limit for this team? I mean, 8-0 and, still going here with a couple games to go in the regular season, which are crucial, critical games. Before the NCAA tournament, how much better, maybe specifically, can this offense play, if it hits its peak here?
Oh, I think the sky's the limit for this offense. Obviously, we've had a ton of playmakers. You know, I think we're hitting our stride as an offensive line. And, you know, Coach has said in the past couple weeks, even when we're playing good games, we're leaving points on the table. So if we continue to get better and keep progressing every day, you know, we consider week by week it's a stepping stone. So when we won the Liberty League, great, but we're on to the next one. And we're going to take that analysis every game, and we're going to see how far it takes us. But, you know, we've got a lot of great players in this team. Defense is playing unbelievable, so the sky's the limit, honestly.
All right, thanks, guys. Again, joined by four-fifths of the offensive line. It was great to catch up with you guys. We'll let you head off to practice, and good luck the rest of the season. Appreciate you joining us. We'll be back for the second half, Union versus Utica. Here it's halftime. Union leads Utica 10-0. Andrew Santillo in the broadcast booth. Want to again thank those guys on the offensive line, Tim Driscoll,
Chris Kachadurian, Teddy Hood, and Max Langsam for joining us with that interview that we recorded yesterday before practice began. When it, if you can believe it, well, you're not here, but if you could believe it, it was much colder yesterday at about 4 o'clock when the team was getting ready for practice. We're in the high 30s here in Schenectady. Probably the coldest day, if not if you're taking yesterday out, coldest weekend we've had, certainly, of the mid-fall, if you will, late fall, I guess, as we make our way towards Thanksgiving, which is when Union hopes to be still playing. 8-0 team already punched a trip to the NCAA tournament and leading Utica 10-0 here at halftime. We'll take a look at some halftime stats, then a shocking score from down the road in Troy as RPI leads Ithaca 38-12 with 4 minutes to go. And boy, oh boy. Union beating Ithaca last week 31-21. You thought Ithaca would come back and want to prove a little something, especially with maybe the playoffs still to play for. And RPI is having its way with Ithaca right now, 38-12. That's only got 2 minutes left because that game started at noon down the road in Troy. So especially for Ithaca quarterback Joe Germanario, who's basically playing in his hometown of Troy, looking at him, he's thrown a couple of interceptions, a couple of touchdowns. But that's certainly a score I don't think many people were expecting, especially because Ithaca a week ago at this time was 7-0 and ranked 7th in the country, and now appears to be headed for its second straight defeat. Some halftime stats here. First half, Union outgaining Utica 99 yards to 72. Not many yards. Joseph Ferrara, one carry, 21 yards. Bellamy, 6 of 9 for 68 yards. Passing yards, Union has the edge 68-34. Utica 38 yards rushing the ball to Union's 31. Ferrara did have a nice run. That wasn't his only run, so I'm not 100% sure. I'm trying to take a look here. Yeah, Ferrara... sorry about that. Take a look at the stats here. Sheet. I was looking at a sheet that I think was previous. Total yards here, Union 216, Utica 108. Union out passing yards has the edge, 132-69. And rushing the football actually has the edge, 84-39. We look at some of the individuals for Union. Will Bellamy, 12 of 21 in that first half for 132 yards, no touchdown, no interception. Finn Duran was a big target in that first half, 3 catches for 52 yards. Andre Ross Jr., 4 catches for 42 yards, but he went out of the game on his last catch, didn't get hit, ran out of bounds, kind of looked like maybe a muscle issue, and he has not been back in the game. Ike Irbor, 11 carries for 46 yards, and Joseph Ferrara, 8 carries for 39 yards on the ground for Union College. Defensively for the Dutchman, who also saw Brandon Scadlock go out early in the game and didn't return. Evan Gillen leads the way with 7 tackles. DiCaterino, Lama, and Reed, 4 tackles apiece for the Dutchman defense. For Utica, Ryan Van Galen, 7 of 19 for 69 yards, no touchdown, 1 interception. His top receiving threats, Palmer and Doherty, 2 catches apiece. Rushing-wise, Warmack had the big rush, a 21-yard rush. Brad Doherty, 7 carries for 14 yards. Jamarius Morgan, 3 carries, only 1 yard. And they've mixed in Hogan, who's had 2 carries for 4 yards. Defensively for the Pioneers, Kwasi Adu, 7 tackles. Derby and Anthony Bobrun. Derby has 6 tackles. He also got nicked up in that first half. Bobrun, Nish, and Scala, and Walpole all have 5 tackles in that first half for the Pioneers. So again, if you're looking no matter what happens now next week, because Ithaca's losing, I believe that means Union's going to win the title outright, even if they were to lose the Dutchman Shoes game next week. Because Ithaca losing two games at the end of the season here, they'll have two Liberty League losses. And Union, even if it loses next week, would finish the league season at 5-1. Obviously, they want to finish the league season 6-0. So, still halftime here at the break. Teams starting to trickle back out onto the field. Union leads this one 10-0. Both teams had a field goal blocked in that first half as they
Welcome back to the field, the Union College Dutchmen.
The scoring in the first half, 6:42 of the second quarter, Will Halpin knocked a 35-yard field goal through to put Union up 3-0. Again, in the first quarter, both teams missed a field goal. Union had a field goal from Marcos Rodriguez blocked, and then Makai Medici missed a 45-yard field goal, came down and hit the crossbar and went out. So that was the first score, came at 6:42 of the second quarter. Will Halpin's 35-yard boot put the Dutchman in front 3-0. 3 minutes later, 3 minutes before halftime, Joseph Ferrara with a 3-yard rushing touchdown, which capped a 5-play, 56-yard drive and put the Dutchman up 10-0, and that's where we stand at halftime. Union College football and Union College athletics would like to thank the following sponsors for their support through the 2019 season. Brown Coach, CDPHP, Center Street Pub, Courtyard by Marriott, Mohawk Harbor, Curtis Lumber, Doubletree by Hilton, Trusco Bank, Dunkin' Donuts, Hampton in Schenectady, Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub, Price Chopper and Market 32, Ortho New York, New Country Lexus of Latham, Sefq, Northeastern Fine Jewelry, Douglas Alman Commercial, Homewood Suites, The Union Inn, and Wolf's Beer Garden, all proud supporters of Union College and Union College Athletics. Teams back out onto the field. Union received the opening kickoff, so Utica will get the ball to start this second half. Union leading it 10-0. And trying to obviously win this game, get to 9-0, but also trying to keep everyone healthy. As we saw a couple players go out in that first half, Brandon Scadlock, a junior defensive back. Also, Andre Ross Jr. went out after going out of bounds on a reception, and I.K. Irabor was a little bit banged up or slow to get up on one of the plays. So Union with a 10-0 lead obviously wants to win this game, get to 9-0, but also wants to stay fully healthy before the big game next week against RPI, the Dutchman Shoes game, right here from Frank Bailey Field next Saturday to end the regular season. And for Union, they hope to keep the Dutchman Shoes trophy and try to get to a perfect 10-0 mark and head into the postseason with a higher seed. As we mentioned, the regional rankings came out this week. First regional rankings, Union was ranked fourth in the East. Top five, Salisbury 7-0, Wesley 6-1, DelVal 8-1, Union 8-0, Western New England 7-0, then Ithaca 7-1, Brockport, Cortland, WPI, and Wilkes, all of those teams 6-10 are 7-1, although Ithaca just lost, so they're 7-2, and they'll play Cortland next week in the big Cortica matchup. Kickoff taken by Tim Hogan near the sideline. He brings it all the way up to the 25, and that's where he's taken down as we start this second half. Union fans, Union Athletics would like to thank Nico's Pizzeria and Rooftop Tavern, located on State Street in downtown Schenectady. Nico's serves lunch, dinner, and late-night food. Also has daily specials. Call for delivery, Nico's Pizzeria and Rooftop Tavern, located on State Street in Schenectady, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics. Well, we talked about trying to stay healthy, and on the kickoff, a Union player is shaken up. Looks like coming off under his own power.
First and 10 for the Pioneers.
Number 27, Dante Scott. Shotgun snap for Van Galen. And running left is Brad Doherty. Doherty gets a couple.
Number 9, Austin St. Pierre.
So Scott made his way over to the sideline. He's sitting on the bench, took his right shoe off, the junior from New Orleans. Having that foot looked at on the sidelines. Second down and 8 after the 2-yard run from Doherty. Van Galen in the shotgun has that slap, then they spike it to him. He hits his tight end. That's J.J. O'Connor. And O'Connor is pushed out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Short pickup of maybe 3. It'll bring up third down and 5. Fans making their way back to the seats here as we're just over a minute into this third quarter. Union leading Utica 10-0. Big third down here, 3rd and 5. Union defense trying to get off the field. Van Galen has that clap of the hands, and then he looks to the sideline this time, trying to get Union to jump off sides. This time he slaps it and gets the snap. Pass complete on the far side. They give him a nice spot on that far side. Keegan Wright, and they're going to move these sticks for a first down. Chambers was in coverage. He came up, made a nice hit, and they gave Utica a nice spot. First down and 10 for the Pioneers at the 35. Snap, pass, swing pass complete to Peyton Miller. And he steps out of bounds. I would imagine Utica is trying to get Peyton Miller more into the mix.
Tackle on the play, number 3, Travis Denby. Second down. Second and 7 from the 38.
In that first half, Miller had, I think, just the 1 catch. They did look for him a couple times. Here's Van Galen. Pocket collapses. He's scrambling to the left, and he gets taken down. Big hit in the backfield by Jamar Edwards, the freshman from White Plains. Edwards able to get into the backfield and knock the quarterback down with his arm, as Van Galen was trying to get outside the pocket. A little slow to get up is Dan Gioso, the junior from Walpole, Massachusetts. So he comes to the sideline. Again, Union continues to see these players get nicked up here. Dante Scott was running up down the sideline. He still have that foot checked out. Was injured on the second half kickoff. And now they take a look at Gioso down on that on the sideline. Third down and long after the Edwards sack. And Galen has four receivers. Shotgun snap. They're looking for a little screen, and it's knocked down by George Reed, senior co-captain, and that'll bring up fourth down. Boy, oh boy, this Union defense, very opportunistic. Had the one interception in the first half from Mark Zazzaro, and Reed with his hands up, heads up type play to knock down that third down pass and force a punt. So here comes Makai Medici, Justin Fea standing at the Union 40. Medici's got a nice high punt, although this one is a short one. And it's caught at the 40 by Justin Fea, who calls for a fair catch. And so Union will have the ball at the 40-yard line to start first offensive drive of the second half for the Dutchman with 12:05 to go here in quarter number three. Shotgun snap for Bellamy. Handoff Irabor. Irabor trying to find some room. Gets all the way to the sideline and then pushed out of bounds after a short pickup of two. Now they give him three. But Irabor, who was nicked up in that first half, comes back in the second half. Gets the first offensive carry for the Dutchman. Before Union, they had a tough time getting the offense going in the first half as... On the first drive, they had a couple of Utica penalties that assisted them in getting down the field before they had a field goal blocked and then didn't score any points until the six-minute mark of the second quarter. Play-action pass. Bellamy looking up top. He's got a man. It's Sermon, and he makes the catch. First down, a big catch as Will Sermon, the junior from Louisiana, his 15th catch of the season, and that was the first big play from this Union offense this afternoon as Bellamy and Sermon connect. All the way down to the Utica 16. Here's Irabor, bounces it outside, and he's knocked out of bounds.
Push out of bounds by number 8, Kwasi Adu.
Kwasi Adu.
Second down.
Also in the area, Elijah Bell for this Utica defense. Give Irabor about 6 or 7 as the ball is at the 10. Second down and about 3 or 4. Union taking a long time to the sideline here. They got to hurry up. 5 seconds on the play clock. Bellamy gets him to the line. Shotgun snap. Give it to Irabor. Irabor.
IK Irabor on the play.
Is swallowed up by a few Utica defense players, including Jack Derby. Senior co-captain from Fonda, New York. Getting in there to make the tackle. Irabor gets maybe 1 or 2. It's going to be third and short from inside the 10. Third and short here. They just brought number 92, Jack Stenson, defensive lineman, in. he's going to block. They're going to run to the left with Erebor, and Erebor is going to get close to the first down. No indication yet, although I think they got the first down based on the line judge coming in from this near side. And they're going to say it's a first and goal tackle by Robbie Shemp. But they brought in a heavy set with Stenson coming in, the junior defensive lineman at 6'3", 250, who's still out there, number 92. Bellamy looking back to the sideline. You also got tight end Spencer Crystal lined up behind the offensive line, offset to Bellamy. And now a timeout. Timeout Union with 8:38 to go in this third quarter. So head coach Jeff Behrman didn't like something that he saw, and he elects to take his first timeout of the second half. Union fans, Wolf Beer Garden in Schenectady offers the best German local and craft brews. Join us for lunch, dinner, and weekend brunch, plus every Wednesday for Union Night, your official tailgating and away game watch party for Union College football, plus men's and women's hockey. Wolf's Beer Garden says, go Union! A proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics, the Wolf's Beer Garden.
The winning number on the purple tickets, 812-304. Once again, 812-304 on the purple tickets. To pick up your prize, please report to the press box located atop the bleachers at the 50-yard line. Good luck, everyone.
Money goes to money. Money goes to money.
First and goal for the Dutchman. Bellamy takes the snap, gives it to Erebor. Erebor running right, trying to get to that goal line, and he's stopped.
Tackle on the play, number eight.
Shane Walpole in there, and Quasi Adu.
Shane Walpole, second down, second and goal.
So give Erebor a couple. It's second and goal now for the Dutchman. Bellamy looking back to the sidelines for the play call. 15 seconds on the play, 8:05 to go here in the third. Good crowd on this cold afternoon here in Schenectady. Bellamy takes the handoff, gives it to Erebor, trying to get to the edge, and he's turned back.
Tackle on the play, number seven, Anthony Boburn.
Seven, Bobrun up from the secondary. It also looked like, I think it was Marquez Lott Douglas. And we got a Utica player shaking up on that far side. I think that was Lott Douglas, the junior from Rochester, up to make the stop on second and goal. Brings up third down and goal for the Dutchman with 7:37 to go in the third quarter. The Utica player makes his way off the field. Looks like Bellamy's maybe having trouble seeing the signals. We are, it's later in the year. The sun's kind of back behind the Union sideline. He's kind of trying to shade his eyes. Erebor on third and goal takes the handoff, surges up the middle. No indication. They're going to say he's short of the goal line. It's going to be fourth down and goal.
Tackle on the play, number 96, Marquez Lott Douglas.
Lott Douglas in there on the tackle. Had 18 tackles this season coming in. Fourth and goal, Union no hesitation. They've got the offense still out there. See what the Dutchmen do here on fourth and goal. Bellamy with Erebor behind him. Takes the snap, gives it to IK, and IK is going to be stacked up and stopped. The snap was a little high, and Bellamy bobbled it. And then tried to get it to Erebor, and Erebor was just turned around and stood up before he could get to the goal line. So a big play for the Utica College defense. And I think Yerebor actually lost a yard or two back to maybe the two or three, and that's where Utica is going to take over first and 10. Well, big play there for Utica. This game still very much in the taking here. 10-0 Union with 6:23 to go. This game very much still up for grabs. Utica's going to have its quarterback, Van Galen, in the end zone. Takes the snap, hands it off, or gives the handoff. And going up the middle, still pushing the pile.
Second down.
And getting out near the 10-yard line was Doherty. Give him about 4-5 maybe on that first down.
Brad Doherty on the rush.
Come on, UD!
Ball placed at the 9-yard line.
Snap give to Doherty again. He's got some big hole to the left side, and he's out over the 20.
Brad Doherty on the play.
First down for Utica. Maybe the Pioneers' best run of the game as Doherty breaks one out over the 20. Pickup of over 10 yards and a first down now for Utica as we go under 5.5 minutes to go in this third quarter. Three receivers for Van Galen, all to the near side. He's got Doherty in the backfield with him. Hands it off, and Union is right there as Dan Gioso in the backfield to take Doherty down. A big loss there as Dan Gioso breaks through and gets into the backfield. Leads the Dutchman with 5 sacks, and that's another tackle for loss for the junior from Walpole, Massachusetts. Well, we talked to Coach Behrman before this game about the offense and defensive lines, and Union's defensive line has done a terrific job this afternoon. Throw and off the hands of Kevin Warmack.
Kevin Warmack.
Warmack was up at the 30-yard line. Would have been close to a first down. Instead, it's going to be third and long for the Pioneers. 4:29 to go in this third quarter. Union leading 10-0. Four receivers, three to the near side here for Van Galen. Looks back to the sideline for the play. Gets the snap. He's going to loft it up. He's looking for Warmack, and flags fly as Paul Chambers was in coverage, batted it away, and flags are going to say that he was maybe there a little too early, although it looked like pretty good defense. They both kind of went up for the ball. Certainly wasn't egregious, but if you're Chambers, you'd rather give up the 15 than about 40 that they were going through for the air. Although it was third and long, so you want to knock that ball down and avoid a penalty. Instead, the penalty will move the football out to the 33. It'll be first down and 10 Utica. And now a bunch set here for the Pioneers. Man goes in motion. They give it to Doherty, kind of a counter play.
Brad Doherty on the play.
And he is
tackled on the play, number 20.
Met by Cam Adams, sophomore linebacker.
Ball placed at the 37-yard line. A gain of 4.
Pickup of 4 for Doherty. Second down and 6 as we go under 4 minutes to go in this third quarter. Well, Union has just 10 points, but they were stopped on fourth and goal at the 1, and they had a field goal blocked. Here's Van Galen, play action. Drops it off, and it is caught and going out of bounds is number 40. Anthony Goff. And Goff stays down on this near sideline after being pushed out of bounds. also spotted right near the first down marker. And they're going to give Utica a first down. Ball's at the 43. It's exactly where they needed to get to. Actually, it's a Union player down on this near sideline, not Goff. It's senior co-captain Evan Gillen. Gillen gets up to his feet, gets a nice round of applause here from the crowd at Frank Bailey Field. Looks to be favoring that left side as he took Goff down out of bounds. First down and 10 Utica, 3.5 to go in this third quarter, Union leading 10-0. Miller goes in motion, handoff up the middle with Doherty. Doherty still on his feet, and the whistle blows. Utica sideline was not happy that the whistle blew, but they called Doherty down at the 49. The ref was pointing down to the field as if he had a knee touch. 6-yard pickup for Doherty. 3 minutes to go in this third quarter. Union defense trying to get off the field here. Utica trying to drive the length of the field after the fourth and goal stop. Van Galen turns, hands it off. Driving for the first down is Hogan, and he's going to get into Union territory and have the first down at the Union 46. Fitzgerald and Edwards in on the tackle. And it's a first down for Utica. Up the middle run with Goff. Actually, that was number 11. Lamont McGriff. So Utica's worked a lot of running backs in. We see McGriff in, Goff was in, Morgan and Doherty, as well as Tim Hogan. It's still McGriff in the backfield in the pistol. Second and 8. They give it to McGriff, and he is trying to roll over tacklers and gets to the 40. It's going to bring up third down and short. Gioso, St. Pierre, and a whole host of Dutchmen in on the tackle. So bring up third down and 4 for Utica. This has been a long drive as in terms of length and time of possession. We've got a minute to go here in the third quarter. Still 10-0 Dutchmen. Shotgun snap, Van Galen has time, he's going to look up top. And it's caught on that far sideline and in for a touchdown. Keegan Wright. Van Galen connects with Wright and it's Wright's third receiving touchdown of the game. And just like that, it's 10-6. As Utica gets on the scoreboard here with 52 seconds to go in the third quarter. They've been taking a few shots at Paul Chambers. Chambers was running stride for stride with Wright, but Wright had just one too many steps, and he was able to get into the end zone. Extra point up, and it is good from Makai Medici. And with 52 seconds left to go in this third quarter, all of a sudden we got a new ball game here. Union leads it 10-7. First touchdown given up this afternoon by the Union defense. Union fans, visit Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady, open for lunch and dinner before or after Union games. It's the place to watch college football and hockey with friends and family. Again, that's Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics. So the long drive by the Pioneers, which started all the way down in the shadow of its own goal after stopping Union on fourth and goal.
Mitch Carley to kick off.
It was a 40-yard pass from Van Galen to Wright for the touchdown. Taking the ball at the 11, and a big hit delivered. As Kevin Robox, the freshman from Westport, Connecticut, came out and got knocked down pretty hard at the 27-yard line, and that's where Union will start, first down and 10. Dutchman leading at 10-7 with 48 seconds to go in this third quarter. Both teams missed field goals in the first quarter. Union scored 10 points in the second quarter, and Utica has the only touchdown so far in the third quarter. That's where we are, 10-7. Fake the handoff to Ferrara. Union's going to go up top with Sermon, and it's just out of the reach of his hands as they were looking for Will Sermon. Bellamy and Sermon have already connected on one long pass this afternoon, and that one was just a little too far for Sermon. Boy, oh boy, and then a penalty behind the play as John Strawn was flagged, and it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. That's going to move the football out to the 42. Boy, oh boy, Utica's had some difficult penalties in terms of being difficult. You can't take a penalty like that or commit a penalty like that. When you've got second and 10, you've got all the momentum, and all of a sudden you give the Dutchman 15 yards out to the 42 and a fresh set of downs with 41 seconds to go, and they flagged Strawn. Bellamy, play action pass, looking for Sermon again, and it's incomplete. Number 26, Terrence Toussaint, was in coverage, the freshman from West Orange, New Jersey. So it's second and down. Union's offense, again, scored 10 points in the second quarter, all 10 of its points. They've had a field goal block back in the first quarter, and then we're on the last possession. We're stopped on fourth and goal, just outside the end zone. Pistol set with Ferrara in the backfield. They give it to him. He makes a nice move at the line of scrimmage, gets to the sideline. And a nice pickup for Joseph Ferrara on what may be the final play of the third quarter as Ferrara gets up to the 49. It'll be third and three facing the Dutchman potentially as the first play of the fourth quarter with 10 seconds to go in the third. And the Dutchman are going to watch the clock run out. So Utica has the lone touchdown in this third quarter. Well, now they get to the line, although the clock runs out, and that'll be the end of the third quarter. Three quarters in the books. It's Union 10, Utica 7. Make sure to stay with us here. We got a good one brewing from Frank Bailey Field in Schenectady, New York. After three quarters, it's Union 10, Utica 7.
Brown Coach or Brown Travel for all of your charter and travel needs.
Union Athletic fans have an online store for all of their shopping needs. Visit UnionAthleticsGear.com for replica jerseys, Union gear, and gifts for that Dutchman fan in your life. Visit UnionAthleticsGear.com. Again, we got the holidays coming up for that Union fan in your life. Visit UnionAthleticsGear.com. Some third quarter statistics. again, that that drive for Utica took 5.5 minutes, 11-play, 98-yard scoring drive, capped by a 40-yard pass from Van Galen to Keegan Wright. So after three quarters, total offense, Union has 281, Utica 195. 173 of Union's yards is through the air. Bellamy, 13 of 24 for 173 yards, no touchdowns, no interceptions. Ike Irabor, 19 carries for just 63 yards. Ryan Van Galen, 12 of 26 for 126 yards and a touchdown. Bellamy is going to get sacked, taken down in the backfield. Number 7, Anthony Beaubrun, came through and made the big hit. Bellamy was lucky to hold on to that football. And so it goes back to the Union 37. It's going to be 4th and long, and the Dutchmen are going to bring out the punt team. So Union leading 10-7, first play of the 4th quarter is a sack. And now Will Halpin out to punt. High hanging punt, fair catch, called for, and now bobbled. It's loose, and Utica looks to have recovered. Boy, oh boy, the Pioneers dodging a bullet as one of the coverage men bumped into the returner, or to the guy who was going to catch it. The ball went rolling along, and none of the Union players could hop on, and it was recovered by the Pioneers. So Utica's going to have good field position here, first and 10 at its own 36, trailing by just a field goal, 10-7. Well, we talked about it even when Tom Arcidiacano was up here joining with us. You know, this is a classic game where you had a huge game last week. You've got a rivalry game next week. This is a non-league game that kind of just is in the middle. We already saw Ithaca got walloped by RPI. Running left is Doherty, and somersaulting his way out over the 40 to the 41. 5-yard pickup on first down. Joe Vanderhoof, senior from Schuylerville, New York, up to make the stop. So now the Union defense has to make a big play. They've had one turnover, an interception from Mark Zazzaro in the first half. But the Utica offense feel like it's got a little momentum. Van Galen hands it off. And they push it, and they're going to be close to the first down as it looked like Union had the play stopped. But Doherty keeps those legs moving out to the 45. It's going to be third down and one. Lot on the line here. Union 8-0, number 14th ranked in the country, leading by a field goal with 13 minutes to go. Third and one. What does Utica draw up here? They're going to run it with Doherty, and Doherty's going to get the yards for the first down. Not a terrific play. But they get the yardage needed out to the 46, exactly where they needed to get to, and it's a first down and 10 for the Pioneers. Van Galen, play action. It is, he throws. He's looking up top, and it's just out of the reach of Keegan Wright. Those two connected on the touchdown pass. There is a player down for Union. Can't see the number on it. I think it may be Travis Denby, number 3. He's laying at the far sideline, right where the 20 is for the 20-yard line of Union. So Van Galen tried to go up top again with Keegan Wright. It was close again as Union had two guys in coverage. Demby trying to walk off. He's favoring that right side. Union fans, Trusco Bank is proud to be a leading community sponsor of Union College Athletics, offering residential mortgages, hometown checking, and friendly personal service. Trusco Bank has been serving our community since 1902. That's Trusco Bank, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics. Denby still making his way off the field here.
Second down.
It looks like they were getting pretty close to snapping it. He's still not even off the field yet. Utica has certainly shown that they can make the big play as Van Galen and Wright connected on that last drive, a 40-yard touchdown pass. Second down and 10 from the Utica 46. Shotgun snap. Looking out to the far side and out and over the head, too far for Peyton Miller, and it'll bring up third down and 10. Well, Union defense needs a play here. Third and 10. 12-17 to go in this game. Union leading 10-7. Four receivers for Van Galen. Shotgun snap. Van Galen has time. Throws it over the middle, and it's knocked away. Terrific defense by Cass Knox, knocking it out of the grasp of Peyton Miller. So that'll bring up fourth down, and that's exactly the play Union needed, as the punt team and Makai Medici will come out to kick it away for the Pioneers. Union is set up as if Utica may fake it. Low snap, and Medici digs it out and sends one of his high punts. Takes a Union hop outside the 20, and that's where it'll be down. So Utica avoids disaster there as a low snap was picked up by Medici, and he's able to boot it away. Union will get it first and 10 from its own 23-yard line with 12:02 to go. Union fans, Brown Coach is the official charter company and a proud supporter of Union College Athletics. Call Brown Coach or Brown Travel for all of your charter and travel needs.
First and 10 from the 23.
First and 10 for the Dutchman. At their own 23, they give it to Ferreira. Ferreira stacked up in the right at the line of scrimmage, maybe got a 1 or 2 yards as he falls forward to the 25. Well, Union just trying to get out of this one now with a victory. They lead it 10-7, trying to stay unbeaten, and also trying to continue some momentum as we come to the end of the regular season with the big Dutchman Choose game next weekend here at Frank Bailey Field. Play breaks down. That was Bellamy on a keeper. Gets up to the 30.
John Strome. Third down, ball plays at the 29-yard line.
Tackled by John Strawn, the freshman from Long Island. Third down and call it 4 or 5 here from the Union 29. See if the Dutchman offense can make a play here. Bellamy, slant, caught. Getting away from a tackle is Finn Duran, and he's got the first down, much more importantly, out to the 45. Somehow got out of a tackle, was right near the line to gain, then got out of the grasp of the Utica defense and got up to the 45. Finn Duran has had a nice game this afternoon. Pistol set for Bellamy with Ferreira standing behind him. He'll give it to Ferreira. Looking to run right. Gets through the initial line and then is being twisted back. while he's down on the ground, got to the Utica side of the field, kind of was down awkwardly, and then the Utica players looked like they were kind of just trying to push him back over himself. Pickup of 7 on first down. It's 2nd and 3. Haven't seen Erebor out there in a while. Haven't seen Ross Jr. since the first half. 2nd down and short for the Dutchman on the Utica side of the field. Ferrara has the first down, and he gets tackled after a nice pickup on 2nd down. Gets to the Utica 43. Pickup of 5. Ferrara with a kind of a little counter play. He's nicked up. As Ferrara coming off the field there, he's replaced by Griff Wallner. And now Union in no hurry. Play clock down to 5, under 9 minutes to go in this game. Union leading 10-7. Waldner right into the game, takes the carry, does the sophomore from Half Moon nearby. Shenandoah High graduate, same high school as Utica's quarterback this afternoon, Ryan Van Galen. Got to the 39, give him 4. And I think Union is going to be quite deliberate down at this end of the field with 8:15 to go. Try to run some clock and maybe punch in the game-winning score here, leading by just a field goal, 10-7. You give it to Wallner, running right, got some room before he's met in the second level by 39, Antonio Scala, senior co-captain for this Pioneers defense. 3rd and short, Wallner got to the 35. 3rd and 2 here. Third down and 2, Bellamy in the pistol. Gives it to Wallner. Wallner not going to get there. Got back to the line of scrimmage. That's where they're going to mark him down. It's going to be 4th down. And what do you do here now if you're Union head coach Jeff Behrman? Looks like he's heading down to talk to his defensive coordinator, Rick Flanders. Ball spotted at the 35. I think Union goes for it here. Now Union runs out the punt team. Utica scrambling to try and get its punt defense on the field. They fake it at 1st down up the middle. Running up the middle is George Reed. They had a fake punt last week against Ithaca, and a big fake punt here as George Reed took the snap and ran it up the middle to the 28, pickup of 7, and a 1st down for the Dutchman, and that is a huge play. So they caught Utica. Utica got its defense, or I should say its special teams, out onto the field, but it wasn't ready for that fake punt from Reed, and now Union is just going to try to run this thing out with Wallner running right, pickup of 1 to the 27. Thank you. timeout as Max Langsam, right tackle, freshman from Damaris, New Jersey, comes off. And we've said it a few times, Union is trying to stay healthy in this game. Obviously, you always want to win, and the win is probably the most important thing, but you need to keep everybody healthy, and Union's had a few players go off with injuries in this game. Wallner trying to find some room up the middle, gets to the 25. It'll be third down there with 5 minutes to go. Union hurries to the line to try to get Utica off guard and not set. Now they get back, look for the play, and now get back to ready to play here. Third down. Here's Wallner. Wallner hit by his own lineman, now bounces off of it, and he's going to have the first down. Well, I don't know, actually. I think they marked him short. I think Wallner originally, it looked like he had it easily and then kind of didn't get a great spot, I don't think, on that far side. It's going to be fourth down. So now another interesting call for head coach Jeff Behrman, as you've got the ball at the 19. Do you, if you tried a field goal, you still would lose with a touchdown on the other end, as it would still be a one-possession game. So going to keep the offense out on the field here. Fourth and one, and now timeout called by Union head coach Jeff Behrman. Union fans, Wolf Beer Garden in Schenectady offers the best German local and craft brews. Join us for lunch, dinner, and weekend brunch. Plus, every Wednesday is Union night. Wolf's is also your official tailgating and away game watch party for Union football, in addition to men's and women's hockey. Wolf's Beer Garden says, go Union. Wolf's Beer Garden in Schenectady, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics. Fourth down and one, huge play here. Shotgun snap, they give it to Wallner. Wallner's got the first down. Well, Union's gone for it a couple times here on fourth down, including a fake punt, and they keep this drive alive. Well, it looked like the initial indication is it was a first down. They still haven't moved the sticks yet. Wow, now they're going to measure it. Wow. It looked like the early indication was it was a first down pretty easily, I thought. I mean, it's... So now they're going to bring out the sticks. 3:41 to go. This is our first measurement of the game, and obviously no bigger one. First down, Dutchman. Boy, oh boy, that was that was close. As Griff Wallner on fourth and one gets just enough. Referees talking it over here, trying to, I guess, spot it correctly here on first down. Union doesn't really care where it's spotted now, as long as they move the sticks and it's first down. 3:41 to go. And a fresh set of downs for the Dutchman. clock running down here. Union in no hurry. 3:25 to go, but only 8 seconds on the play clock. Now they get the play in. Bellamy in the pistol. Turns, hands it off for Wallner. Wallner goes inside the 15, took a couple of big hits. Brown, Young, and Nish in on the tackle. And timeout now as Utica players down on the field. Dutchman leading this one 10-7 with 3:07 to go. Trying to see who it is for Utica up to his feet. Andrew Caruso, a sophomore defensive lineman from Pittsford, New York, just outside of Rochester, making his way off the field. Well, I'll tell you, Utica has played a good game. I mean, they just scored their first touchdown in the third quarter, but I mean, they are a team, and when we talked to head coach Blaise Fagiano, trying to get to the postseason, and had a big win last week against Alfred, which he said basically saved their season because the goal was back-to-back winning seasons. They went 7-4 last year and defeated Ithaca in the ECAC bowl game. Pioneer sitting at 4-4 here. We're trying to finish their season out, regular season out, on a win streak, get back into a postseason game. Union running this clock down, 2:35 to go. I think that everyone on the Union sideline would feel a little bit better if they put in another score here, though. Wallner running right, and he's taken down at the 15, may have lost a yard. And Utica's going to spend another timeout. So Union's going to have to do something here because Utica's spent two timeouts. Now it's third down. And I don't think Union wants to kick a field goal here because you'd be up by six and a touchdown would go ahead of you. However, the Pioneers have a very accomplished kicker in Makai Medici, who has missed one field goal today off the crossbar on a 45-yard attempt. Third down and 7 or 6 from the 15. They got Wallner running right. He gets maybe only 2 yards, and we'll see if Utica spends its final time out here. And they are going to, with 2:10 left. And now, what do you call if you're Union head coach Jeff Behrman? Because it's 4th and long, say maybe 5. They're going to kick a field goal here. Looks like Union's setting up to call out the field goal team with 2:10 remaining. This is the side of the field where Union had its first field goal attempt that was blocked. So they are going to set up with a field goal. Looks like it's going to be about a 31-yarder. Tim Guiney is the snapper. Zach Christian is the holder from the right hash. Halpin's kick is up, and it is good. Big field goal there for Will Halpin, a 31-yarder. Halpin's got two this afternoon, and Union goes up 13-7. So the Dutchman now up by six with 2:06 remaining. However, if you're the Union defense, the only touchdown you've given up in this game was a long 40-yard pass. And so now you really cannot get beat with 2:06, beat deep, I should say, with 2:06 to go in this game. Union 2 minutes away from improving to 9-0. We talked about it on the way in. Union, one of just 12 remaining undefeated teams in the country. Last time Union was 8-0 was back in 2005. One of the guys we had up here in the first half, Thomas Arcidiacano, was on that team in 2005. That team, not only did they go 8-0, they went 10-0, then they went 11-0, winning their first NCAA game, and then losing in the second round to Rowan. So Halpin will kick it off here with 2:06 to go. Halpin short kick, it bounces, is fielded by that's number 23 for the Pioneers, Jamel Smith, and he takes the short kick and brings it all the way out to the 45. So Utica's going to have terrific field position here, 1:56 remaining. I shouldn't say the 45, the 43. But Utica's going to have good field position here. First down and 10 with 1:56 to go. I don't think they have any timeouts left. It does, scoreboard says one timeout remaining. I don't believe Utica has any timeouts. I think they used all three of them. 1:56 to go, although when the clock stops on first downs, they've certainly got enough time here. Van Galen. Gioso coming after him. Flag flies. Pass is complete. Utica's going to try and hurry to the line, but we're going to get a holding call here, I believe, on Utica. I think that was called on 57, Ryan McCormick. And that is not what Utica wanted, as it's going to move the football back to the 33. So Union would like that. They like Utica going in that direction. It'll bring up first down and 20 with 1:49 to go. Union leading 13-7. Van Galen has four receivers, three to the near side. Drops back to pass. Throws it up. And it drops incomplete, looking for Peyton Miller. And it'll be second down. Well, on a day where the Union offense scored well under its average of 36 points per game, the Union defense, which has allowed just 14 points per game, is going to be out here trying to win this thing for the Dutchman and improve Union to 9-0. Second and 20, Van Galen in the shotgun. Four receivers, three to the near side. Gets the snap. Has time in the pocket. Completes the pass to Keegan Wright. Wright gets up to the 45, and that's where he's taken down. Clock rolls, 1:20 to go. Third and 8. Van Galen's got to hurry him to the line. 1:10 to go. Drops back to pass. Union rushes four. Big hit on Van Galen, and the pass is incomplete. And Union is, I would think, a little lucky there because Gioso gave Van Galen a pretty good shot. And now it'll be fourth down. Union sideline trying to get behind its team. Fourth down and 8. This is the game here for Utica. Trying to keep this thing alive. 1:05 to go. Crowd is as loud as it's been all afternoon. Union leading 13-7 with 1:05 to go. Van Galen gets the snap. Union, it's knocked away. Cass Knox They were looking for Palmer, and that'll be it. A turnover on downs, and that will do it as Union will get the football back, and the Dutchmen are going to improve to 9-0. So Union is going to come out, and it looks like just take a couple knees, and the Dutchmen are going to be 9-0. It wasn't easy. It may not have been pretty. Bellamy will take a knee, and this clock's going to roll. Give credit to Utica. They came on the road here in a game that they're playing for their postseason lives in terms of ECAC games or potentially New York Bowl. And Utica played very well. But Union is going to get out of here. They're going to get to 9-0. They take a couple knees, and that'll do it. The Dutchmen are going to win this game as the clock rolls down. 25 seconds still on the clock. They're keeping both teams on the sidelines here as... Now the coaching staff starting to walk onto the field. Under 10 seconds to go, and that's going to do it. Union is going to improve to 9-0 with a 13-7 victory over Utica College. So Union will be 9-0 next week for the Dutchman Shoes game, which will be right here at Frank Bailey Field at noon next Saturday. Union will host the Engineers of RPI. Union will be looking to complete a 10-0 season. We'll take a look at some final statistics here. Union, again, with a tight 13-7 victory over Utica College. Some final statistics here. Union outgaining Utica 329-217. Outgained through the air and on the ground did the Dutchmen over the Pioneers. 189-138 through the air. 140-79 on the ground. Individually, I.K. Irabor rushing 19 attempts, 63 yards. Joseph Ferrara, 12 carries, 61 yards and a touchdown. The only touchdown for Union on this day. William Bellamy, 14 of 25 for 189. No touchdowns, no interceptions. Four catches apiece for Finn Duran, Andre Ross Jr., and Griffin Beal. And defensively leading the way, Evan Gillen, 9 tackles. 6 tackles for Cam Adams, George Reed, and Vinny DiCaterino. Mark Zazzaro had the lone interception in this game, 15th interception for Union this season. For Utica on the ground, Brad Doherty, 16 carries, 52 yards. Kevin Warmack had 1 carry for 21 yards. Ryan Van Galen, 13 of 33 for 138 yards and a touchdown, also threw an interception. Keegan Wright had 4 catches for 71 yards and a touchdown for the Pioneers. Quickly recap the scoring in the second quarter. Union Will Halpin's field goal put Union on the scoreboard. 35-yard kick with 6:42 to go in the second quarter put Union up 3-0. 3 minutes later, before half, 3 minutes before halftime, Joseph Ferrara's touchdown run made it 10-0 Dutchman. The only score in the third quarter came late in the third quarter. A 40-yard pass from Ryan Van Galen to Keegan Wright capped an 11-play, 98-yard drive, Utica's only score. That made it 10-7. And then Will Halpin kicking a 31-yard field goal with 2:06 to go. Halpin had 2 field goals, and Union 13-7, 6 points better than Utica. They improved to 9-0. So some thank yous to hand out here. Thank you to Jim McLaughlin and the athletic director at Union College and his staff. Thanks to Steve Sheridan, his sports information staff. And thank you to both head coaches, Blaze Fagiano, for chatting during the week, and then also Coach Jeff Behrman, who joined us in the pregame. Thank you to Thomas Arcidiacano, who joined us in the first half, and also some of the members of the Union offensive line who joined us at halftime. And Thank you, as always, to the Fighting Dutchman Gridiron Club, and as they support the broadcasts here. And thanks to you, the listener, for tuning us in here, unionathletics.com, and watching this game as Union wins 13-7 and improved to 9-0, and they're going to be back for the Dutchman Shoes next week at 9-0. RPI coming off a big win against Ithaca today. So I think the Engineers will be 6-3. So that'll do it here from Frank Bailey Field. Andrew Santillo signing off. Your final score, Union 13 and Utica 7. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it here from Frank Bailey Field. Thank you. Good afternoon, and we'll talk to you another time. Union, again, improves to 9-0 with a 13-7 victory over Utica College. Thanks for listening.